And welcome back to the Red Hawk Sports Network. Tonight we got some awesome coverage of NJAC playoffs. Brandon Marazzo joined by Anthony Caffone, men's soccer here at MSU Soccer Park. And we got the Scarlet Raptors on the pitch right now, about to take on the Red Hawks. They've already faced each other this season. That matchup ended in a draw, but all previous history goes out the window right now. It's tournament time. If you didn't know, this is where it's at, and how you feeling right now?
Maz, this is the atmosphere right now. MSU Soccer Park hosting two straight NJAC playoff games. Tonight the men's are playing, women's play tomorrow. But right now this is the game we're focused on, the Scarlet Raptors coming here into Montclair to take on the Red Hawks. Should be an interesting matchup. You mentioned their prior history, the draw only 9 days ago, so that familiarity is pretty common. So now the Red Hawks have to come out here today and play a good solid 90 minutes.
Hey, we know that both teams came in with pretty solid records. I mean, Montclair State literally won the NJAC regular season, champions of that, with a 8-0-1 NJAC record. They have a 14-1-4 regular season record. And then, of course, Rutgers-Camden coming in with a 7-7-7 regular season record, 4-2-3 in the NJAC. But as we said, last time we saw these teams, at Rutgers-Camden looked to park the bus, and it paid off. They came away with the draw, and they've been clawing their way to stay alive in this tournament. We know that they just went to a rough game last time out, and here they are against the Red Hawks. What are you thinking about this one?
Yeah, Maz, this Rutgers-Camden team is very good at just keeping the pace of the game in their area. I mean, they were able to draw with this Montclair State team, which is not an easy task to do. They had the best record in the NJAC this year, regular season NJAC champions, the 11th ranked team in the country coming into this one. So Rutgers-Camden was able to play with them for 90 minutes, not allow a single goal to their high potent offense. So the back line for Rutgers-Camden really has to do a good job today of just staying back, not taking any too unnecessary risks, and then just playing those through balls back over to the other side.
Hey, I'm glad you mentioned that back line, because Pedro Jovel Castro and Grant Williams did a fantastic job at shutting down Josiah Crawford last game. But Josiah Crawford, Amir Lukovic, I mean, they are on the NJAC all-first team, so this is really going to be a matchup, and you can definitely tell that both teams are going to be looking to get back at each other. I'm sure Josiah Crawford's looking to find the net. I'm sure Lukovic trying to find the net, but it's going to be hard with those speedy wingsters. And you know, also Raimondo Partito for Rutgers-Camden, that's a big part. It's going to be a challenge. However, this is probably the best attack that we've seen in quite some time in D3 soccer, and Tumulty's men, I think they're hungry tonight, Ant.
You spoke on it yourself. They've outscored teams so far this season 41-10. That's just all the entire regular season, 41-10. That is absolutely crazy. They almost have a 4-1 goal ratio. That is probably the best we're ever going to see in a few years. It's just been a great year for this men's soccer team, but you know, it doesn't happen without an NJAC title. You know that this is the time where you're supposed to really go out there and prove to everyone in the NJAC that this team is legit, because it's easy to go on in the regular season and win, you have, you know, 14, 15 games and do your thing there. But when it comes to these high intensity situations, winner take all games, this is what true soccer, what true teams are made of.
You got that right. And you know, you talk about the legitimacy, and everybody knows this team's legit. I mean, Tumulty just got a co-coach of the year award right now, and I believe 8 players were selected and honored by teams. Run us through those teams.
Keenan, of course. I mean, Keenan,
I believe it was the goalkeeper of the year.
Goalkeeper of the year in the NJAC. I mean, him and Del Val have had a great job splitting time and goal this year for the Red Hawks. He'll be probably getting the start tonight. Then you talk about Altamirano. I don't think he's playing tonight, but he was spectacular all throughout this year. So keep looking for him to be a spark plug within that midfield. Ian Chesney, one of the best defenders who can score on the other side. He goes up and down the field. You don't know where he's going to play. He can play center back whenever you need him to. Josiah Crawford, speed on that wing, continues to just go down, find some area, led the team in goals this year. Amir Lukovic, another player that we just talk about, just quietly continuing to be dominant. I mean, last year he had over 14 goals. This year he comes back with 9. Just continuing to play consistent, great soccer. Nira Doncic, another great player that continues to just work up in front into the front line. I mean, these players all throughout this Montclair State team have continued to play. Owen Murphy, a player that we didn't even talk about yet. He's just a great leader, shows great poise on that field. A couple of goals so far this year, but he does a good job just setting up from those cross passes. Just continuing to get these players players on the field getting reps. I mean, you let the backups play last night against CCNY in a 5-0 shutout. They were able to do a good job of just meeting the place. And when you have a bench like that, they can go out and win a 5-0 game against another school. That just shows you the depth and the play from this team.
Hey, you got that right. And the back line for me, really, you mentioned Randonsa, you mentioned Chesney, but don't forget about Justin Goldberg and Alex Zelanka. I mean, this back line, doesn't matter who's in goal, they do their job, they show up. Owen Murphy setting the tempo in that midfield. I mean, Montclair has just dangerous weapons all over the field, and it's going to be an interesting one for sure. But let's not forget about the Scarlet Raptors and their main guy, Michael Campbell, on the other side. I mean, this is going to be a matchup for the ages.
Campbell just got elected to the second team All-NJAC coming into this game. Had a very good season overall. Had 2 goals, 3 assists. He's not a big point scorer. You're not going to look to him all the way to get those points. But he's a good job of just mediating the pace. A good midfielder who just does his job and is really getting more possessions for his Rutgers-Camden team. And, you know, in order for them to win tonight against this red-hot Montclair State team, they're going to need everybody to be flying full speed along the pitch, get some good opportunities in front, and just mediate that time of possession.
Hey, you got that right. And you know, it all starts with the guys on the field, but let's not forget about the brains behind the operations. We talked about Timothy in his 11th season, setting the tone, changing around the program, doing an amazing job. And on the opposing side, Tim Oswald. Talk to us about him, please.
Yeah, Oswald in his 17th season, graduated at Elizabethtown College. He's done a good job this year of keeping this Rutgers-Camden team in games. They like to play aggressive, like to get some possessions on their side, and they like to attack. I mean, you talk about Montclair State and Timelty, he likes to press. He likes to press in that backfield and just force turnovers. And Rutgers-Camden is going to look to do the same tonight, just based off what I've seen so far from them this season.
Hey, we know that they parked the bus a little bit and were looking to counterattack. Do you think they're looking to get into that extra time area, or do you think they're going to be a little more aggressive instead of playing defensively?
Nah, come on. You got to play aggressively. That's no way to play in a playoff game. You can't really be conservative and really focused. Because if you play conservative against this Montclair State team, they're going to make you pay. Because we talk about their aggressiveness. Be as aggressive as you can. Don't take stupid risks, but do your job and get the points.
Hey, we'll be right back with you here on the Red Hawk Sports Network after the playing of the national anthem. And we are back here at the Red Hawk Sports Network. Once again, Brandon Morazzo joined by Anthony Caffone. And we're just about to get started here. We got some starting lineups. We see the teams just finishing up their warm-ups and getting together for one last pep talk. But first, let's hit the lineups with the Scarlet Raptors. We got number 2, Pedro Javel Castro. Number 4, Parker Soloway. Number 8, Ethan Dreyer. Number 10, Daniel Tittlemeyer. Number 14, Liam Craver. Number 19, Michael Campbell. Number 22, Raimondo Partito. Number 28, Eric Swen. Number 34, Grant Williams. And in goal, number 44, Sean Boone.
And he talked about Michael Campbell in the opening, but also two other players that elected the NJAC All-Second Team, Eric Swen and Sean Boone, the goalkeeper, second-best goalkeeper in the conference. Look out for him.
Hey, Boone, last time he played against Montclair State, he was a wall. He wasn't letting anything get past him. It was a phenomenal effort. We'll see what he handles here tonight against the Red Hawks. But now, for the Montclair State Red Hawks, first, number 2, Alex Zelanka. Number three, Justin Goldberg. Number four, Ian Chesney. Number five, Anir Rendoncic. Number eight, Owen Murphy. Number 10, Amir Lukovic. Number 11, Josiah Crawford. Number 12, Anthony Viola. Number 13, Donovan Davis. Number 20, Brogan Quigley. And in net, the reigning best keeper of the NJAC of the year, number one, Shane Keenan.
Yeah, this is going to be a great matchup. I mean, the two best goalkeepers in the NJAC this year, Shane Keenan and Boone, are going head-to-head. It's going to be one of those big defensive showdowns, I think. Not a lot of scoring today, Mazmi. You saw nothing shutout last time these two teams played. I expect a low-scoring game. Maybe we might get PKs tonight.
You know, that how spectacular would that be? I mean, of course, if you're either fan, you want to see your team take the lead and not look back. But here, as broadcasters, I'm here for the story. I'm here for the PKs. This is exciting, man. How you feeling? This is probably the biggest game me and you have been a part of here at Montclair State.
Yeah, I mean, this is the game. I mean, they were we had both Montclair State men's and women's getting home playoff bids because they're both top regular season champions. Congratulations to them, by the way, before this game starts. But when we were getting ready, I was like, this is going to be a big game, probably the biggest game of the season for this men's soccer team, just to be out here and see this environment play out. It's going to be something special.
And, I mean, this game is so it's so big. You see the refs warming up on the sideline. My man was getting a little jogging there, the line judge. When's the last time you seen a ref stretch before a game like that?
It's a tense atmosphere, and you see Brogan Quigley in the lineup today for the Red Hawks. He hasn't had a spark so far this season, so getting some fresh legs in this playoff game is imperative, and the grad student so far this season is going to be looking to mend the tide in the midfield.
Yep, we're just waiting to get to kick off here, waiting on the ref's whistle. Of course, Montclair State in the classic white tops with red bottoms, and Rutgers-Camden in all black. And we are off as a through ball over the top from Liam Craver will roll out of bounds and give the Red Hawks possession. This throw in now with Goldberg.
Yeah, look for a lot of through balls from this Rutgers-Camden team from midfield. They're going to try to get their attackers in front, try to avoid the offsides penalties, and just see if they can get good, you know, looks 10 feet in front of the net. It's up to this back line. Chesney, you know, you see him back there along with Zelanka. They're going to be a huge factor in trying to just catch up to these through balls and not letting any good opportunities pass.
Hey, and we know the back line of Chesney and Rendoncic aren't afraid to put in some through balls of themselves, as Chesney here in the neon cleats sends it up the neon green. That one, little missed time. Rutgers-Camden taking over at midfield, getting it over to number 10. Passes back, that's Tittlemayer, giving it back to Grant Williams, who slides it over to the center back. And both teams looking to pick their moment. But now you see the Red Hawks pressing, doing a good job. That ball falling with Chesney. Owen Murphy on the press. Montclair getting started early.
And Maz, there's always that instinct in playoff games to sort of get away from your game. If you're playing a real physical team like Montclair State does, they play a real physical game, to sort of get away from that and not take too many risks. But I'm just here to say, don't get away from your bread and butter just because it's the playoffs and this is a win or die.
As the ball comes in, that one's headed. Crawford on it, putting the cross back towards center. No one there. Montclair trying to hold on to possession. Chesney gives it back to Zelanka. Zelanka passing it back. And you saw Zelanka had that through ball over the top, trying to get it to Viola. Viola having a tough job taking on Pedro Javel Castro. Watch that matchup all night long. Him and Grant Williams for that Rutgers-Camden side will be all over the field.
Javel Castro, a very physical player, likes to get a lot of tackles, try to draw that ball loose, and then start more possessions on the counterattack. Red Hawks got to be aware of him because he's got a boot for a leg.
As Murphy boots that one out, listen, we know the talent that are on these teams. This is a quality matchup on paper. Montclair State looking like the favorites.
I mean, they're the 11th ranked team in the country coming to this game, as they are one of the top dogs, not just in the NJAC, but in New Jersey and in the country. So they're still going to try to play what they need to do. They're the ones that have the pressure on them. I feel like Rutgers-Camden's got nothing to lose tonight. They know that they're not the favorites on paper, but just go out here and just have fun and try to win a game.
As they do just go out there and have some fun with a turnover, this ball hitting over to Javel Castro. Castro receiving it back. And now a long boot going towards the deep side of Montclair State. And a header back to Shane Keenan. Both teams pressuring. I mean, you just see them in a whole nother gear right now. Chesney sending a deep ball, looking for Viola. Viola racing, trying to keep that one in, taking a little contact, and they will give that, I believe, that will be a goal kick with Boone.
Yeah, Montclair State last season was also the reigning regular season champs. Couldn't get it done in the playoffs. Kane ended up winning the NJAC last season. So, you know, if you're head coach Todd Timmelty, you don't want another repeat of that. This is the year where you can right the ship of last year. This is definitely a better constructed roster than last year. So, I mean, this is the chance with this departing class to really get a chance to win an NJAC title.
And another long ball from the back, looking for Lukovic. This time settled, passed out to Crawford. Crawford cutting back in, takes the shot right into a Raptor, still pressing. That ball going out of bounds and will be a goal kick with Sean Boone.
They love to put Crawford here, that center back, right on that right wing and see if he can just lay over a pass in the middle. That time he just tried to cut back, move, and try to put one on the ground, but right there, good defense in front of the net by Rutgers-Camden to prevent even an attempt for Boone.
And Boone booms that one back across midfield. Radoncic playing it back to the keeper. Keenan now opts to go short, gives it to Chesney. Chesney crossing the field of play back to Radoncic. Montclair trying to mix up the tactics, looking at all possible attacks. That ball to Davis. Davis back to Radoncic. Montclair creeping up to midfield. Donovan Davis sees Zelanka, gets it over to him. Zelanka now with some space.
They like to use Zelanka up top here to try to do a long pass in, try to get a header to Chesney. Chesney's playing back this time, though.
And Zelanka on the ball, giving it back to midfield to Davis. Davis with a little miscommunication there, but Goldberg keeping it in. Montclair just passing around, hanging, looking for an opening. And a ball in, oh. And Boone can't hang on to it. Crawford on top of it, and they
offsides. And they call it offsides on Lukovic.
Offsides. That was close. I mean, you saw Lukovic getting up there, trying to make a play. Sean Boone coming off his line, not able to hold on to it, and they might have just caught a lucky break there, the Scarlet Raptors, because the Red Hawks were goal hawking.
I mean, that was a good pass up front there, right on the doorstep for Lukovic. Lukovic just had a couple steps too far, but a good chance there from the Red Hawks, and you got to like that. Just continuing to just pound the box, find some of those shots, and they're looking like they're spreading it out really early, getting guys deep passing lanes. Zelanka's been getting a few of these passes on the other side.
Speaking of Zelanka, he's got the ball right now, flipping it up for Crawford. Crawford speeding pass, trying to get a pass back in. It falls to a Red Hawk, and a shot comes, but it will be far. That looked like
Murphy, I think.
I believe that was number 20, Brogan Quigley, on the shot. Just trying to put the Montclair on the map, going wide.
Yeah, I talked a little bit about Brogan Quigley in the open. Not normally a guy that starts, only two starts on the season coming into this game, and he had a nice chance right there from about 25 yards out and just hooked it way wide left.
And Murphy now on the ball, getting it up, flipping it to Lukovic. Lukovic bodying a defender, fighting for it, trying to keep it in bounds, but that is some great defense by Eric Swen. Swen.
I mean, a foul called him against Montclair State on that far side.
I guess they said that Lukovic just got a little too aggressive. You saw Swen with the hand clap, loving the call. This will be a free kick here for Rutgers-Camden.
Montclair State already two shots in these first 7 minutes compared to none for Rutgers-Camden. So trying to get the pressure early. And I think Montclair State hasn't even allowed one opportunity in that back third for Rutgers-Camden. So really mediating this possession. That's the one key I said coming into this game, just continuing to just pass smart and efficiently and not let Rutgers-Camden have too many chances down that back third.
And great communication for Montclair State as they quickly lose the ball, but that pass to set up the switch of play. You saw Goldberg call for Montclair on the press. Crawford fighting with Grant Williams. Josiah Crawford winning the ball. Now trying to set up a Meg, but Williams holding strong. Montclair still pressing that ball, going out of bounds, and will be a throw-in for Rutgers-Camden after Anthony Viola came in with some help defense.
Almost a dangerous mistake there by Grant Williams. He let that ball get past him, trying to make too much with his He looked up while he was trying to play with the ball on his feet, and it went right through his legs. Crawford right there to gather it up, but an unfortunate error, but lucky recovery.
Speaking of an error, Donovan Davis takes a foul. This will be a free kick in a dangerous position here for Montclair State. Looks like Owen Murphy will be manning this one.
Yeah, Murphy likes to take these free kicks right here, about 30 yards out on the right wing. And just see who can get in that opportunity. I think Chesney likes to take these headers. Look for Chesney to try to put one in the back of the net.
As we're just awaiting, you think Murphy's going to take it, or you think he's looking for a pass here?
No, I think he's going to Chesney here for the header.
All right. Murphy puts it high towards the back of the box, and a header comes soaring out of bounds. That will be a goal kick.
Yeah, not a great kick from Murphy there. He hooked that one way too much to the left. Had to put a little bit more touch on that one, tried to get it towards that back post, but he couldn't really do it, and Rutgers-Camden gets the ball back, as it looks like he sure slipped on that kick.
Grant Williams getting the ball back, flipping it up, and a smart move there from Zalanka to let that one go out of bounds. Owen Murphy now on the ball, gives it back to Randoncic, who gives it over to Justin Goldberg. Goldberg now looking for a moment here, ups to pass back with Chesney. Chesney and Randoncic, both of them center backs, but their passing and vision just absolutely top notch. Randoncic now at midfield, showing off the moves and giving it back to Chesney.
They're not forcing anything, which I like. They're waiting for their opportunity. They're just passing back and forth and getting that Rutgers-Camden line to keep moving with the ball, maybe try to open up a hole and see if they can attack that. They're just being patient, and they're not forcing anything, which is fine, because the more clock you waste, the more time it takes Rutgers-Camden to really not do anything.
And Rutgers-Camden on the ball for a moment. That ball will roll out of bounds and be a throw-in for the Scarlet Raptors. Montclair trying to point and get that possession back, but line judge says not tonight.
The Raptors really got to do a better job, though, of just trying to force something, because it just seems like they're just waiting for Montclair State to attack, and they're not really going out there and trying to make a play. They're waiting for it. They're letting the game come to them, and I think in this early part, they haven't really seen even the Montclair State middle third so far. The Red Hawks have just been doing a good job of just mediating the pace of play.
Chesney with a long ball, looking for Lukovic. Lukovic fighting Pedro Castro. Shot coming in. Goal! Amir Lukovic putting Montclair State on the map, bodying multiple Scarlet Raptors and banging in a low shot right past Sean Boone. And what did you think on that one?
That started with that Chesney pass. Had another good opportunity. Found the box. Lukovic doing a great job positioning, staying on sides, and then finding that near side post corner. And right past Boone. Good job by Amir Lukovic, the Montclair State goal leader coming into this game. Just having a phenomenal season, doing it best. And in the playoffs, continuing to play great. And Montclair State takes a 1-0 lead.
Well, you hear the pump it up. Sounded here right now, and what a goal that was. I mean, he was surrounded. You saw Pedro Javel Castro in his pocket, and he just bodies his way right through it. I mean, what a display of power and control. Great goal there. We saw them pressing, and the goal comes in. It pays off. If you are Rutgers-Camden, you got to get a little more aggressive on the offense.
I mean, Amir Lukovic is probably one of the best strikers in the conference this year, first team all NJAC. We talked about it in the open, and he just showing why. Just trying to find space. He beat numerous defenders on that way to that goal. And he's frankly probably been the best goal scorer in the NJAC these last two seasons. Kid's only a sophomore, just remember that.
That is absolutely insane. as we almost have a close one here with Montclair State, but they're able to hold on. Ian Chesney now on the ball again, getting that one back to midfield. However, both teams fighting for it, and it looks like Anthony Viola will have a race here with Jovel Castro. Pedro Jovel Castro getting it past and winning the foul. This will be a free kick for Rutgers-Camden.
I think you just got to launch one deep here for the Raptors. Just try to get something going. Put a couple of strikers deep in Montclair State territory and just let it boom. Try to see if you can get some space to make a shot, because right now, the way that they've been rolling, they can't get any space to move up the field.
And they send that one in, and this one headed out of bounds as Montclair tried saving that one, but to no avail. And now again, the Scarlet Raptors trying to switch the field of play.
It just seems like they're out of position right now, man. They got numerous defenders blocked off in the passing lanes, and Rutgers-Camden really has no way to move up because Montclair State's just all over the place and their players are just cut off.
Well, Owen Murphy was leading that press, and it pays off with a forced turnover there as Lukovic now on the ball. Quigley and Crawford trying to keep it in. Just a little miscommunication. Throw-in for the Scarlet Raptors now. Crawford on the ball, gets it over to Lukovic, who receives it back. Nice pass from Murphy. Shot coming. Sean Boone all over it.
Just the ability to even get a shot off in that situation where Crawford was just stuck in the corner. Made a great move to get it by his defender, and two great passes with touch passes and freeing up Lukovic for a shot. I mean, that's why this Montclair State offense is so great, because they make opportunities out of pretty much nothing.
Yeah, this team has just been fuego all year long, obviously. As again, they are still pressing. Donovan Davis trying to come up with a midfield interception, forcing the Raptors to go back with Sean Boone. Crawford almost sneaking on in there. The ball now falling with Grant Williams. Williams looking upfield. Was looking for number 14, Liam Craver. Couldn't link up with them. But Josiah Crawford swooping on in there, taking on multiple Raptors again. This time, Scarlet Raptors hanging tough. And again, Montclair just keeping the pressure on here, winning the ball at midfield once again.
They're playing physical, they're playing fast, they're playing with a motive right now, Maz. It just seems like this team has the energy right now. Rutgers-Camden's got to find a way to really bust through and try to match their energy.
Solanka mistiming it with Quigley. Number 14, Liam Craver on it, getting it over to Tittlemeyer. Tittlemeyer receiving the ball back, putting a ball up into the air, trying to make something happen there. Looking like number 19, Michael Campbell, couldn't keep it in. This will be a goal kick for Shane Keenan.
And Shane Keenan, first goal kick of the day for him. Try to see what his strategy is. He might play it short, and that's exactly what he's going to do. The Redhawks are doing a good job of just keeping the offensive patient and trying to work for something on the offense. No need to boom it if you have a one-goal lead already. Just keep working the pace you have, because it just seems like it's working. Like Montclair State before, they used to be an ultra-aggressive team. They would have 20, 25 shots a game. And right now, I mean, you look at it in these first couple of minutes, they're only sitting at four shots. So they're just playing a really slow game and just working for the perfect opportunity, which just seems to be working.
Hey, I mean, they're picking their moments, but when they go with the moments, they are flying as they win a throw-in out of bounds. The last game we saw these two, and you saw Rutgers-Camden kind of set the tone a little bit. That's not happening here tonight. Montclair State in full control of this one. 29 minutes remaining here in half number one. Montclair State still up 1-0 as a Raptor tries to clear that one. Ball up into the air. Montclair State trying to take over. And
oh, good tackle from Crawford there. Get that ball free. Now Montclair State's got good space, but Aaron passing Murphy. But how do you say that ball? That was a good job on that sideline.
They just make the second effort plays, and this is what they do. Montclair State now with possession. Ball going back with Anir Radoncic. Radoncic surveying, taking his time, switches it over to Zelanka. Zelanka over to Crawford. Crawford back with Zelanka. Gives it back to Crawford. I mean, they are just on the same page. This is immaculate right now. Get it over to Viola, Viola, over to Zelanka, back to Viola, creeping on the box, fighting near the edge. That will be a foul. Foul.
That's me on Zelanka there, and a little bit of contact on that far end line.
Viola, that will be on Viola. The 12-2, a little hard to see in that back corner. Anthony Viola fighting, trying to make something happen, but just a little too aggressive as a Rutgers-Camden player hit the pitch. Sean Boone getting it back to midfield. Brogan Quigley heading that one. And they'll call that one off of number four, Parker Soloway. That was close. But Montclair State with another chance on the attack.
Earlier today, Rowan took down Ramapo in PKs to punch their ticket to the NJAC final. So the winner of this game will be taking on Rowan. So that this is a recent development. They played at 2:30 today. Ramapo, the number two seed, getting upset by Rowan.
Yeah, that's definitely going to be an interesting one for either team going forward. But right now, you got to win this one because the winner goes home. Am I right?
Exactly. I mean, that's you say it like that, you got to win this game because that's just you don't have that game after this win.
And again, players fighting on that back corner. Montclair State winning the throw-in.
Now from these throw-ins, I want to see if they get one of their better throwers to try to see if they can force that in the middle. Get some good lift on it. Setting up back there, and look at this.
Good call, right into the box. A heading effort there, looked like from Lukovic. Will fall right to Boone. Now Tittlemeyer passing it back to Grant Williams. Williams getting it back to midfield, where number eight fighting for Ethan Dreyer. Dreyer gets it over to Soloway. Soloway putting the ball up into the air, into the box. And this time Montclair over it completely.
First good opportunity there for the Raptors, though. Soloway tried to do a touch lift pass right on that far side post. Should have taken himself, though. I think he had a better chance of just taking himself and trying to get a good shot on Keenan. But good opportunity for the Raptors nonetheless.
And this ball now with Josiah Crawford. Crawford showing off the moves. That Neymar S speed coming, trying to turn the corner, puts the ball towards the center, and a no-nonsense clearance coming from number 28, Eric Swen. Throw in now for Montclair State.
He's continuing to get that ball in the box, the Red Hawks' motto today. They are not wasting any time when they get in this back third. When they're in the front third, they're doing a good job just staying patient. Once they get in that back third, though, they are going flying into that box and trying to get a goal.
And speaking of the ball in the box, ball on the edge of the box, and Lukovic looked like maybe Murphy trying to put that one up. And this ball going out of bounds will be Rutgers-Camden ball. Yeah, I believe that was Owen Murphy just trying to bang that one towards the net. Now Tittlemeyer on the ball. Crawford trying to come up with it. Oh. Almost stealing that one from Williams. Williams might have got the best of him last time out, but Crawford has been all over him this game. Crawford getting it over to Quigley. Quigley not seeing Pedro Jovel Castro sneaking up there. Good turnover there from the Scarlet Raptor. Jovel Castro on the ball, getting it up to Soloway. Soloway mistiming it and saved by number 14, Craver. Craver turning the ball over. Chesney taking some contact, and ref coming over talking with Soloway. Just giving him a talking to. Chesney taking a bit of a shoulder, no card. Ref just giving a talking.
I like that call, though. I mean, it didn't seem like it was intentional.
He tried giving the advantage.
Yeah, so Chesney ran to his back, able to, a little contact. You got to call foul, but a good call, not the yellow card. And now you got Chesney here, big boot right at midfield. Look at that kick.
And he puts it towards the net. Swen puts it down. Ooh, and Anthony Viola trying to put a rocket towards net. Just missed timing that one. That ball flying out of bounds. Goal kick for the Scarlet Raptors.
Yeah, Viola had a great chance. It looked like Boone sort of mishandled that ball. Bounced right in front, but a good block and recovery by that Scarlet Raptors defense. And the Redhawks, once again, dangerous opportunity in that back third. They're just finding it. And another good tackle. I mean, these tackles today from the Redhawks team has just looked great. They're just getting the ball free, especially Josiah Crawford. I mean, he's just doing a good job of just poking that ball free whenever the other guy has it.
Yeah, that tackle was 13, Donovan Davis, trying to come up. You saw him. He just spins the guy, puts him right on the pitch. Montclair State now with possession. Aniran Doncic getting it up with Lukovic. Lukovic crossing over to Goldberg. Justin Goldberg fighting with it and losing possession. But Lukovic coming in with a hard tackle, wins it back. Now marching into the box. Shot coming. Ooh. And a laser just over the crossbar out of bounds. I believe they're saying that might have been blocked. This will be a corner for Montclair State. Somebody getting a hand on it might have been Sean Boone.
Yeah, good job there, though, by Lukovic with the left foot, able to create some space. Unfortunately, ball just gets deflected, goes a little bit over the net, but a first corner opportunity for the Redhawks today.
And Anthony Viola will be manning it. Viola putting this one high towards the middle. Randolph trying to go up for it, mistiming. Grant Williams on the ball, trying to clear it. Murphy putting the cross back in, heading up into the heavens there. Montclair State still lurking, and we have a player down that looks like it might be number two. Pedro Jovel Castro might have took a hit to the head there. Hopefully he'll be all right. Some subs coming in for Rutgers-Camden.
Looks like Crawford is heading to the bench as well for the Redhawks. Yeah, so now you're getting your first subs out here about 23 minutes into this one. I think the Redhawks are doing a good job of just keeping the pace of this game in their hands, playing really strong, playing really patient at the back half, and then getting good looks inside the middle. Rutgers-Camden, though, has just got to do a better job of just creating space when they're on the offensive attack. It just seems like everyone's too bunched up. Montclair State's defenders doing a good job of staying in those passing lanes, getting easy turnovers. And they're just playing a little bit more physical right now. It just seems like they're getting tackles very easily. They're being able to get that ball free. You saw Crawford a few times. You saw Donovan Davis had that big tackle there too. They're just getting the ball free, and the Raptors are just committing too many turnovers.
Yeah, I mean, the press is coming. Montclair is just lurking around the net. We've seen some hard shots just miss, and you got to figure the door is going to open again for them. Thankfully, we do have Pedro Jovel Castro up on his feet, still being attended to right now. They're just checking him out, making sure he's okay. Walking off on his own accord. Love to see that. Fans clapping for him. Well deserved. Pedro, I got to tell you, if nobody's ever seen Pedro Jovel Castro play before, I mean, he is just every bit of a pit bull, man. He has tenacity. He's got speed. He takes on guys that he has no business looking at him taking on, but he has the heart of a lion, man, and he's constantly just battling out there. That will be a big loss if he can't return in this one.
Yeah, but and he also he's versatile. You play the midfield, you play back in the back line. He just can play different positions on the defensive side. And using that versatility, they like to do that. Head coach Tim Oswald likes to use him in those different sets, so hopefully he can return in this one.
And now Rutgers-Camden with possession, getting that one over to Dreyer. Dreyer looking for Campbell, but Chesney beating him to it, making sure nothing could happen there, kicking that one out of bounds.
Great play by Chesney there, able to, good recovery. And that's what this back line does. They prevent these opportunities from coming to fruition. And Chesney's right there, able to kick it away and just force the Raptors to throw in. And another turnover for the Raptors.
Ooh, and a hard tackle there, nothing called. Montclair State still battling for it. That looks like Justin Goldberg getting down on the pitch, trying to make something happen as a ball comes into the box. Looks like Tittlemeyer on top of it. Daniel Tittlemeyer trying to get past Crawford and company. Crawford winning that one, getting that one up to Lukovic. Lukovic with Swen right on top of him, still battling through. And that time Lukovic trying to get a friendly call there. The ref says get up. Good call by the ref. and ball going out of bounds. Montclair State's ball. You see.
Luka Vick just trying to go through three defenders right there, and he almost got through there. He was able to just, the footwork that he just displays when he's on the offensive side is just incredible. I mean, we could only ooh and ah over him for so long before it gets to be, you know, too much. But I just got to say, he's just been phenomenal this season. Another great play there on the attack.
I mean, a player like him, it's never too much. Montclair State back on the attack. Lukovic putting the ball, looking for Crawford. Crawford racing, getting a foot onto it, flying past Williams into the box. Still fighting, and a foul is called against Crawford as Williams takes a tumble.
Yeah, I mean, Crawford, sometimes when you move that fast, you can't stop your momentum, and you end up going right into the backside of the defender, and it's going to get called for a foul 9 times out of 10, probably 10 times out of 10.
Listen, I'm going to be honest with you. I am impressed with Crawford. I mean, he remembers this matchup, and he's coming, throwing punches all night long, figuratively, of course. Montclair,
another
Owen
back
Murphy
over.
Taking over. Swen trying to clear. Lukovic almost able to keep it in. This ball flying around Donovan Davis with a header now. Lukovic winning possession. That looks like Viola. Get it over to Murphy. Murphy takes a shot. Not enough juice on that one as it rolls into the hands of number 44. Sean Boone.
It seemed like Murphy sort of slipped there on that shot. His plant foot sort of slid under him, and he was able to sort of slip and fall. And it's a little bit of a slick grass tonight. It just rained a couple hours before. If you're in the New Jersey area, you know what I'm talking about. So the grass is a little bit slick right now. So you already saw a few Rutgers-Camden players slide when they tried to kick it forward. So expect the condition of the field right now to be a little slippery.
And well, we have just over 18 minutes remaining here. And a free kick for Rutgers-Camden. Just waiting on the ref. As they are heading to the side. Oh, let's see what's going on here. Never like to
warning.
See that.
Yellow card?
You never want to see that. As you see refs towards the side. Never a good thing. Just given a talking to. I think some
substitutions
subs,
as
subs
well.
Coming on. You saw the line judge having some words there with somebody on the far side.
So now Montclair State looks like they're having a free kick, or Rutgers-Camden, my apologies, is having that free kick right there on that far side. Try to get this ball into the box. I mean, only one opportunity so far today. It wasn't even a shot.
And a ball put into the box, headed by Chesney. Player coming in, looking, and sends that one deep.
Off a Red Hawk deck.
Off a Red Hawk deck for sure. Wow.
Yeah, and that's what Chesney brings to the game. He's 6 foot, and he's one of the taller players on the field. Being able to be that tall and get up there and win those headers on the defensive side is so crucial for the Red Hawks. He's been doing that all season, and that's why the Red Hawks have only let up 10 goals so far this season.
Yeah, I mean, they're doing just a fantastic job this game. As they take over again, this time looks like Randoncic looking around, putting this one high, finds Crawford. Williams getting his head to it, hitting that one out of bounds, hitting our cameraman Oscar there, shout out Oscar Venegas. That one almost taking him out.
We have an update from Rutgers-Camden. Apparently, so the volleyball team is also playing Rutgers-Camden right now. In the NJAC playoff, they dropped their first set, 25-22, on the road. So they're down 1-0 going forward.
And you see Josiah Crawford showing off the balance, being dragged down to the pitch there. Long jersey pull. Ref trying to play the advantage. Montclair getting the call. The crowd not loving the pull. But this will be a free kick here. Owen Murphy at the helm.
And dangerous opportunity. You can't take that foul. If you're the Raptors in that situation, you're giving Owen Murphy a free kick, who's one of the better guys at hitting these free kicks from this wing spot. And he's going to try to lay one over the top here.
Murphy putting it towards the back post. And a Raptor getting up to head it away. Montclair's Quigley getting a foot on it. Still fighting for it. Murphy and Quigley. Brogan Quigley now in the box, taking on Swen. Quigley falling down, that ball going out of bounds, and they will say this one was off of Quigley.
Yeah, Quigley doing a good job. Being able to keep that ball up in the air and still being able to move, trying to get a good opportunity. But good defense on the Rutgers-Camden to force that one away, get the goal kick for Boone.
And now Boone will have a chance to start the attack up again for the Scarlet Raptors. Lukovic getting a header on it. Cajado now on the ball. Cajado got going down. And a yellow card being shown to the Scarlet Raptors side.
So, yeah, I mean, a yellow card, another foul, another free kick for the Red Hawks. Just doing a good job at midfield of just getting these goal kicks and able to advance it back up the field. And now Montclair State gets another free kick about 30 yards out, and they're going to try to put up in the middle.
And that card will go against number two, Pedro Jovel Castro. Nice to see that he's okay back in the game. Got to be careful with the red card, though, as he's just picked one up.
Yellow card.
Yellow card, my bad. My apologies. Yellow card it was. And now a free kick for the Red Hawks. Too many colors.
Too many colors.
As the free kick comes in, that one headed by Tittlemeyer. But Crawford fighting to keep this one alive. And they will. As a cross coming up. Lukovic settling it over to Chesney. Chesney getting it over. And that has... Wow, what a hit there. I believe that was Jambi Cajado just took.
And Cajado coming off the bench today, usually a starter. He's been dealing with some injuries so far this year and might have gotten a little bit of a Charlie horse on that one, got kneed right through the thigh.
Yeah, that one was rough. You see, I think that was number 22, Raimondo Partito. Coming in on that one, you see some words being exchanged. Ref doing a great job of keeping this one in check right now. And now the Red Hawks in a
another free kick,
another
third free kick in the last few minutes.
Another good position to possibly put another one on the board.
You got to convert on these opportunities for the Red Hawks. I mean,
oh, and look at the defense there from Rutgers-Camden, completely all over. Ball into the box. Radoncic crossing it back. Just too much for Cajado. A Red Hawk on top of it. Chesney trying to put it towards net. And Swen clearing that one out of bounds.
We saw Cajado also slip on that side, trying to get that cross on the other side from Radoncic. But the Red Hawks, once again, another free kick opportunity coming to pass. They got to do a better job on these free kick chances of really getting a better look.
And again, both teams fighting for it. Donovan Davis shielding off Montclair, getting the ball over to Crawford, over to Zalanka. Alex Zalanka putting the ball up, cross-headed by Pedro Jovel Castro. This ball falling with Tittlemeyer, Josiah Crawford lurking. And now getting it with the pressure, that ball going out of bounds.
Yeah, it just seemed like number nine, Kari Sheffer, couldn't really hold on to that one. He was expecting that pass to come a little bit slower and just ate him up.
And some subs coming on now. Brogan Quigley heading off for the Red Hawks. Daniel Tittlemeyer heading off for Rutgers-Camden. Checking in, looks like number six, Bola Watife Sonia, and number 17, Jacob Bartnick. And now it's Prince Bofo with the ball. Bofo sending it up. Looking.
Oh, dangerous play.
Ooh, look at Shane Keenan coming off, taking on the collision as him and Bola Watife Sonia collide. That ball going out of bounds will be a throw-in for Rutgers-Camden. 12 minutes remaining here.
I think it was Radoncic also hustling over, trying to make a play, but Shane Keenan come all the way out of the goal box to make that play. You don't see many goalies taking that kind of risk, but he's got that speed and agility to make it.
And a deep throw coming into the box, headed down. Pedro Jovel Castro gets the foot on it. Castro trying to keep the ball alive. Hands it over to Grant Williams. Williams now looking to put a cross into the box. Crawford on top of that one. Now starting the break. Williams trailing.
Good move from Crawford.
Crawford cutting it back, trying to set up Cagado. That ball going out of bounds. Throw for Montclair State. And looks like we have a player down. Ref coming over. Looks to be in some pain. Thought it might have just been a cramp. Trying to see who that is.
But let's just go back to Crawford's play here in the middle third. Gets the block off of that Williams shot. And then that ball bounces in front. Gets the counterattack going right away. That speed, he's able to just explode. And then go up and cross midfield. And a great move. He made two defenders fly past him. And then try to get that pass underneath. But the Redhawks, once again, just turning that one shot into a quick opportunity the other way. Just that offense and that ability to go right back in transition has just been on display today.
As a Redhawk is getting some treatment, this has been quite the physical game thus far. And I mean, we're only just about 11 and a half minutes in. Multiple players going down. Able to get back up, but what have you been liking thus far from both sides?
You talked about it right there, the physicality. This is the NJAC playoffs, Maz, and this is the time where you got to come out here, be physical, and play a strong 90 minutes. I think Montclair State's doing a little bit better of a job of just winning those 50-50 balls, able to get those key tackles at midfield, and block shots. You saw the one from Crawford right there, and just turning those opportunities into good shots, and it looked like we're finally going to get someone.
Yep, that is number 17, Jacob Bartnick, being helped off the pitch right now. Walking a little gingerly. Hopefully, he is okay. You see Randoncic and Goldberg checking on him. And he will head off the pitch. And Chris Fontanazzo will be checking in. Looks like Crawford will be checking out to get a breather. Zach Crawford heading towards the bench, and yeah. We'll see what Timothy.
Yeah, Timothy likes to sub out his starters like 10, 15 minutes before the end of the half, get some fresh legs out there to close out the half, and then bring the starters back in to start the second half. So now, once again, Montclair State bringing in Fontanazzo
and Peter Lynch.
And Peter Lynch for the injured Bartnick. And now you got to throw in from Zalanka. See what the Montclair State attacks and go here spread out.
As they throw this one over to Chesney. Chesney over to Randoncic. Randoncic coming up. Getting it over to Lukovic, but couldn't hang on to it. And now Montclair trying to win that ball back. And a missed time back heel. Will give Montclair another possession. Lukovic switching it over. The Red Hawks right on the edge of the box. Shot coming. And that was Cajado trying to make his name known once more this season.
Yeah, good shot from Cagado on that one. Just seemed like he had a little bit of space to get one off. Just tried it there. Two goals on the year for him coming into this one. So not a big-time goal scorer, but when the lights are shining on him, he likes to take that shot.
Lukovic now trying to get it over to Cajado. Rutgers-Camden able to hold on for a second, but Goldberg getting that ball back into play. Lukovic near the edge of the box. Pedro Javel Castro holding strong. Throw in for the Redhawks.
Looks like someone else is subbing in for the Redhawks as well.
I believe that is number 22, John Becker. Becker putting it into the box, looking for Cagado. Montclair still fighting with the Scarlet Raptors, hanging on tough. This ball back at midfield will roll out of bounds and be a throw-in, this time with number 9, Kari Shepherd. Kahari Shepherd trying to get that one over to number 27, George Lewis Ferdinand. That one going out of bounds in favor of the Redhawks.
So now Redhawks are going to throw in, go past midfield.
Try to make something happen here. And once again, starting the break, getting that ball. Looks like Fontanaza getting that ball over to Kagato. Kagato tries to play it back to him, but Swen on top of it, clearing that one. Montclair holding tough here. Yeah. Passing it back. Ball falling with Chesney. Trying to pick their moments. Now we're Randoncic.
They're pulling these defenders out. You see Boafo and also Shepard coming up out of their spots to put some pressure on. When you get those defenders pulled out of their zone, that leaves a guy free up and to pass down to. So the Redhawks are doing a good job just being patient, letting these defenders get a little antsy and run up so they can make their opportunity known.
And a tough slide tackle will give the Redhawks possession again. And a handball is called against number 27, George Lewis Ferdinand. Ferdinand could have been off to the races on that one.
Yeah, try to get his body in front of him. Unfortunately, I think it hit his lower arm on the block. So a little bit of a break there for the Redhawks. They're able to get a free kick for Chesney.
Chesney sending that one towards the box. That one headed by Lukovic. Murphy putting the shot on. That ball still in the box. Grant Williams clears it.
And a corner kick. Just goes past that end line. Now good opportunity for the Redhawks to get a good score here with just over 7 minutes left.
And we'll see what the Redhawks can do here. As we said, they are currently leading 1-0, about 7 minutes, 30 seconds remaining. And the Redhawks are now crowding the box as the ref, once again, just giving the players a talking to. A little pushing and shoving on that goal line. And we'll see what they opt to do. Lukovic putting that towards post, just too close to it as that one goes into the side of the net. This will be a goal kick for the Scarlet Raptors.
So they're playing a lot of defenders right inside, or a lot of attackers in the middle of that net, and they wanted Lukovic to have a low liner corner kick right to the inside so they could get a shot inside. I don't know why they did that. I like when they try to get Lukovic and Zelanka also to try to do high arcing corner kicks and have them get running starts. I don't know why they tried to elect to do that strategy inside.
And look at the effort there from Quincy Atobra keeping that ball into play before it does fall out of bounds on that slide tackle. Zelanka on the throw-in. Go short with Lukovic. Zelanka receiving it back. Getting it over to Lukovic once more. Donovan Davis crossing the pitch. Giving it over to number 22, John Becker. And now both teams fighting. Players trying to get through. That ball hit back. And this ball flying all over the place.
Yeah, but still staying on Rutgers-Camden's side. They're trying to just even get that ball back across midfield, but the Redhawks doing a good job of just staying with the play and getting those headers back down.
And a through ball over the top will send it right into the box, and Shane Keaton comes out of bounds. Chesney taking a spill as he collides with looks like number 27. Once again, Lewis Ferdinand.
We got about 5:22 left here in the first half, but stay with us here at halftime on the halftime report, where we will be having the field hockey goalie Lauren Pickle coming into the box for a quick chat at halftime.
Hey, Ann, I'm glad you say that. I was just going to mention Red Hawk Nation showing up right now.
Red Hawk Nation, let's fly.
I mean, the men's soccer team's flying. We got multiple teams soaring this season, and again, a shot coming. Oh wow, Lukovic. Trying to.
That was almost 40 yards out.
He would have had me out the window on that one with that one. I wanted to see it so bad.
And he missed by the fraction of an inch. What a shot. Like, with the left leg, too. Not many players with their left legs can absolutely put in a shot like that. That's what makes him so special. Because he can do it both the left and the right.
Yep, and that one going off of Donovan Davis's head will be a throw-in with Grant Williams. I'm still in awe of that shot. But here we have Fontanaza fighting with it. And they will call a foul.
Okay. I don't know if I agree with that call. Seemed like a pretty clean tackle there from Fontanazza, but
I mean, Fontanazza and Co. were swarming there, and the ref not liking it. Nonetheless, this will be a free kick with number 21, Christian McCarthy.
So finally, Rutgers-Camden get a good chance on this free kick, about 35 yards out. Let's see what he can do.
Sending it into the box. That one's low. We'll roll back to midfield with Grant Williams. And Montclair again. Owen Murphy pressing, just eating that ball, sending it out of bounds. And another throw in here for Rutgers-Camden.
It looked like that free kick was deflected there by Chacon, doing a good job of just being in the wall and getting his body on that one and forcing that pass to get forced awry.
And this time a foul will come from Zelanka. Just getting too much up on the defender will be a free kick. I believe that was number 27 who hit the pitch.
Louis Ferdinand. It looked like he's sort of...
Ferdinand winning balls right now.
Yeah, he's doing a good job of just of getting the calls and playing tough physical defense and attacking on the other side.
So once again, Christian McCartney will be on the free kick. McCartney sending it in. Mistiming. Oh, and a chance blown right in the eyes of Shane Keenan. That was such a missed opportunity there. You saw Rutgers-Camden right a chance to level it. Wow.
And that was a great pass, able to go right to that far side post. He was just a step behind that pass, and he just couldn't get his foot on there. Red Hawks escape with it. As we have an update from Rutgers-Camden, the Red Hawks women's volleyball team win the second set 25-13. They are tied at one with the Scarlet Raptors. So the Montclair State Rutgers-Camden rivalry doing a great job tonight, just going back and forth.
And a ball coming from the back line, headed Murphy, looking for Davis creeping. And that ball sent.
My God, there's a little tug there.
Potentially, as they are still itching, Keenan coming out. Number six for Rutgers-Camden. Bolu Watife, Sonia, showing off the speed. And once again, getting in a dangerous position by Keenan. But Keenan not letting anything pass him.
Keenan doing great, has great instincts. He's able to just come up, see the play developing in front of him, and just slide in and grab the ball away from Sonia. And now Montclair State going right up the field quickly. I mean, now the Redhawks doing a good job. The first couple goal kicks of the game today, they've been electing to play it short and go slower up the field. But now the few times that Keenan's been able to come up and get the ball on a free kick or on a goal kick, he's trying to just boot it deep and get that attacking line for the Redhawks to go quick.
As once again, speaking of going quick, this first half flying by right now as we have just under a minute remaining here. Shane Keenan getting this ball back over to Randoncic. And we'll see if the Red Hawks can make something happen here with just about 30 seconds remaining. Time for one more attack. Chesney soaring that one deep into Rutgers-Camden territory. A missed time header there will give the Red Hawks a good look, possibly looking to put the ball back into the box one last time. As it comes missed time, that ball will fall right to Sean Boone.
And they almost that missed time header for Rutgers-Camden could have proved costly. The Red Hawks had to get their numbers back in front. And that's why he was a little more tentative on that far side. Couldn't get a good crosser in there, but the Red Hawks will have to go into the break with a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, I mean, this has just been an amazing game. But and speaking of amazing, we have one of the best athletes at Montclair State joining with us right now. We have Lauren Pickle, the starting goalkeeper for the field hockey team. Lauren, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing good. I'm excited to be here for their first playoff game for NJAX.
How are you liking the atmosphere of this soccer game? As we know, inter-NJAC play gets a little heated. Talk about the atmosphere you're experiencing right now.
It's awesome. I mean, a lot of people came out, so that's really exciting to see for them. And anytime that it's an NJAC game, whether it's regular season or now playoffs, it's really exciting. And, like, hopefully they can continue this lead and play again on, I think it's Friday.
So, you know, Lauren, you have obviously played in NJAC. Can you just talk about playing, like, these schools that are so close to Montclair and just what the rivalry means to the players?
Yeah, it's definitely a big rivalry because we play these teams every year, and a lot of times, like, within the New Jersey schools, we all know each other, the players on the team. So there's little rivalries with the ones that you played either, like, in high school with or in club before. So it's definitely extra exciting, and that's why we all love NJAC games.
And speaking of NJAC games, your team's actually heading to Rowan to face on the Profs. How are you feeling about that matchup coming up?
I think it'll be good. It's tomorrow at Rowan. Last time we played them, we led into halftime, and it was a really competitive game. So we're hoping that we can take what we did last game and then continue and make some adjustments to win tomorrow.
Gotcha. And can you just let us into an insight of the team's mindset as they prepare for this NJAC matchup? What's going on with the locker room?
I think we're all really excited because I think that we all see the ability for us to come out with a win tomorrow. So we're all excited, and the energy all week at practice has been really great because we all know the team that we're playing, who we're playing, and what we need to do to come out with a win this time.
And when you guys play Rowan, is there just a little extra something in the tank? Is there just something with the mindset? Can you let us in on the a little more on the NJAC rivalry?
Yeah, it's definitely the mindset is that, like, we know that they're a top team in the country, and that for us to come out with a win, like, we have to play the very best that we have all 60 minutes tomorrow. So all of us know that, and I think at practice, like, the extra, like, competition within each other to, like, push each other harder, because we know that those girls and those teams are very talented, and that it's going to take everything we have to win.
Hey, there you have it. Lauren, we thank you very much. Thank you for coming out here, and I'm sure the men's soccer team appreciates the support. Anybody can head out to Rowan to check out the field hockey team. They'll be putting out a fantastic performance. Of course, you've been fantastic in that all year, so we wish you luck in your upcoming matchup.
Thank you.
Have a good one.
Thank you, too.
And we are joined back once again with Anthony Caffone. And, I mean, as we said, we just had one of the best athletes at Montclair State on the mic. We appreciate you giving her your microphone.
Oh, yeah.
You know, but, Ant, we have a soccer game here.
You'd rather listen to her than me. I mean, that's for sure. But, yeah, it'd be a great game so far, Maz. Yeah, you just said it. Both sides coming out here with a lot of intensity. It's been a very physical game. A couple of fouls called. A couple of yellows been handed out. One for Rutgers-Camden. I don't know if Montclair State was handed a yellow card yet today. I don't think they were. But, yeah, it's just been one of those games with intensity. It's the playoffs. Everyone's coming out here and played a good job. Goal from Lukovic so far today. That was a good setup by Chesney. He had the assist on that one, just doing his job in the back line. And the Montclair State defense has looked really good.
Yeah, you know, that yellow card for the Scarlet Raptors, of course, went against number two, Pedro Javel Castro. Castro did take a spill on a header, was able to get back up, come back into the game, then picks up the yellow card. But 1-0 here at halftime. And, Ant, did you think that this game would be that close?
Yes, of course. I mean, look at the last meeting we talked about earlier, Maz. They were nothing-nothing, draw. Only 9 days ago that game was, so being able to see this team twice in 2 weeks is somewhat of a treat, because these two teams just seem to be evenly matched. Redhawks were able to get an early goal, and they did a good job of just spreading it out, being patient, waiting for their moment to strike, and then when they saw that little split in the defense, they went right after it, and they were able to get a goal.
Hey, you know, I mean, they've just been pressing. They're really just forcing the turnovers, applying the pressure. I mean, you saw Lukovic taking on, I believe it was like three defenders plus Sean Boone on his lone goal. I mean, they've just been rotating, just looking like an absolute unit. Timolti not afraid to go to the bench. We've seen multiple players stepping out onto the pitch, getting guys some rest. And as I said, the starlight for me, of course, Lukovic scored the goal. But the way Josiah Crawford coming back against Grant Williams and Pedro Javel Castro after that last matchup, I mean, that is some Mamba mentality right there. I mean, arguably they might have got the best of them last game, but this game, it's been him. I mean, he is turning the corner on them. He is speeding past them. He is just, quite frankly, showing us why he is, in fact, first NJAC.
he's just been given no space on this sideline, and a few times he's just made nothing. He's made something out of nothing, frankly, and that's just what he brings to the table on that right wing. Just great speed. You talked about his Neymar-like speed a few times in this broadcast. He just gets down the field. He's able to find space. And one of the better cross passers we've seen, too. He could just lay a pass over the top for a header a few times. And Montclair State hasn't been able to convert on any of them. But he's just doing a good job of just keeping the game on the wings won. And I think he's one of the faster players in the NJAC you will see. And, yeah, Mads, like you said, he's doing a great job tonight.
Yeah, I mean, fantastic job. As we said, the press doing a great job itself. Owen Murphy and Donovan Davis have looked like demons in that midfield, and they are really setting the tone, setting the pace. I mean, normally you're used to seeing an Altamirano do that. We haven't seen him in this one yet, but his fellow midfielders stepping up and setting that tone right where he has it. And, of course, that back line of Goldberg, of Randoncic, of Chesney and of Zelanka have just been zooming all over the place, making sure nothing getting past them.
And don't forget about Shane Keenan. A few times he's come out of his net to make a sliding grab, and he's doing a good job of just not letting any of these dangerous chances that Rutgers-Camden's been able to get have any validity to him, because he's just been coming out of his goal and doing a great job. I mean, you talked about Murphy, you talked about Chesney. They do a good job of just getting back on defense, forcing the ball out, and then once they get those throw-ins on the side, they're able to just get it back up the length of the field. So it all starts with that back line for the Red Hawks. That's where most of their counterattacks really come from. And I saw that one play by Josiah Crawford where he took a block off of his chest and then was able to just spot the ball right away, go after it, and then go right back on the counterattack, able to just turn those opportunities around against Rutgers-Camden. That's what they've been doing, and Rutgers-Camden has felt that pressure.
Absolutely feeling the pressure. I mean, Rutgers-Camden doesn't even have a shot on goal right now. And, you know, that doesn't prove what Keenan's been able to do. As you said, coming off his line a couple of times there in the face of danger and absolutely fearless. I mean, this is why he's been named the number one goalie in the NJAC. This is exactly what you want to see from your starting keeper. But this team, this Red Hawk team's just been shutting down Rutgers-Camden's attack. I mean, they can't even get towards it, man. Like we said, I just said it, no shots on goal. That is amazing. Believe it or not, Montclair State only has 3 shots on goal, but they've been keeping the pressure. It feels like 60% of the game has been played down in Rutgers-Camden territory.
And that's what you expected, Maz. I mean, this game was supposed to be a game where it was supposed to be, you know, low scoring. They weren't. Defense was going to be on full display. I mean, you said it yourself, 3 shots on goal this entire first half. Both teams are doing a good job of just keeping the ball within midfield. The Red Hawks are doing a better job of just keeping possession. They're staying more at midfield, and they're able to just keep the ball longer. And that's sort of why they have the lead in this game. They've set up the more opportunities. The more opportunities you get, I mean, it's not rocket science. The more goals you're going to score, and that's what the Red Hawks have been able to do today.
All right, listen, they've just been playing like a wild pack of dogs out there. Under control, though, but hunting for goals at every second. If your head coach,
like, this is it's not hard. Just do your job. Work hard, continue to hustle, play physical defense. Don't give them an inch. The moment you let up, that's when, you know, it's only a 1-goal lead. It's not like you're winning by 4 goals, 5 goals. It's a 1-goal lead. The moment you give them an inch, it could turn the game around and turn the tide of the game around just like that.
Hey, you got that right, but it is still a close game, as you just said. You know, 1 goal turns the tide. Tim Oswald on the opposing side, though, he's facing the reigning NJAC regular season champs. We know last time he faced them, there was a draw, and he's sitting here with a whole nother half, his team only down 1-0.
Correction, Maz.
What?
The 2-time reigning NJAC regular season champs.
Two-time. Reigning regular season NJAC champs. You are right. My apologies. If you are Tim Oswald, and what are you telling his players that they need to do to get back into this one?
Just on the defensive side, force a turnover. It just seems right now that Montclair's been having all day to really work at the top of the back third, so they're not really having much trouble just passing the ball around. Play more physical and aggressive defense. Try to get in those passing lanes. Do a better job of just forcing them to try different plays, because it seems like they're getting anything they want. Just the defense needs to be a little bit better, and then on the offensive end, just try to convert those opportunities into scores.
Yeah, you know, and it's definitely some good keys there They have to apply the pressure. They have to be getting better looks. They can't. They've been sitting back a lot and looking for the counterattacks. I think it's time to get creative. It's time to get something going. This has just been an amazing game. You have been watching the Red Hawk Sports Network, Brandon Morazzo, joined by Anthony Caffone. And let's take a look around Montclair State. We know that NJAC tournament is tournament play is starting to get undergone. We just had Lauren Pickle on the broadcast. Of course, Pickle and her squad, the field hockey team, will be heading down to Rowan. We also have the women's Red Hawk soccer team in some play. I mean, how are you feeling about this NJAC tournament play coming up for all teams?
And you forgot about volleyball, too. They're playing right
in
now.
In a match right
they're,
now.
They were at 1-1 set. We're getting updates as that game goes along. They're playing really well against Rutgers-Camden. But, yeah, Maz, field hockey tomorrow against Rowan. Rowan's coming into that game as the number one ranked team in the country. Not just in New Jersey, not just in the NJAC, the entire United States. That's how good this team is. Montclair, they were leading 1-0 at the half last time those two teams played back last Saturday. So they did a good job of really being able to go shot for shot with them until Rowan blew the doors open with 3 goals in that second half. So you talked to Lauren Pickle just before. She said that game built their confidence up. They saw that they could go head-to-head with the number one team in the country for a whole first half. And now they just got to put it together, put the pieces together, and try to do it this time around in Glassboro tomorrow.
You got that right. And of course, for the women's soccer team, I mean, they've been phenomenal all year long. I mean, they have a record of 16-1. I mean, come on. This is why they're nationally ranked. This is why Montclair is seeing a renaissance of soccer happening right now. Any thoughts on that?
They also play Rutgers-Camden tomorrow. This is just the Rutgers-Camden versus Montclair State NJAC season tournament, you know? It's one of those days. And, you know, you talk about that women's soccer team. The Aileen Cahill, Kylie Prendergast 1-2 punch has been the story this season. Multiple hat tricks, multiple multi-goal games. They have just been the dominant pairing in the NJAC this year. Kylie Prendergast likely to be the NJAC Rookie of the Year just based on her performance alone. Just a couple of just great games down the stretch. And then you talk about Aileen Cahill, one of the probably the top goal scorer in the NJAC this year. And she's just done a good job of just getting in that box and just forcing goals. And Haley Martin in goal, she's been spectacular as well. I mean, Dina Velas, another one. She's sitting in the other box right now doing game operations today. We spoke to her a little bit before the game. So this team has what it takes, Maz. I mean, they lost last year in the NJAC playoffs. Coach Nauter, you know how hungry he is for an NJAC title. And this is the season where I think this is the best team they've had in years. So, frankly, if they don't do it this year, it just seems like, is it ever going to happen?
I mean, multiple teams just doing a great job. Of course, as you said, women's soccer here at Montclair State will be taking on Rutgers-Camden at 7 o'clock. I believe our very own Gianna DeGuinness and Campbell Donovan will be on that call. So make sure you check into that one. Make sure you check out all the Montclair State teams. I mean, this has just been fantastic. And you have to think if a certain someone is looking down upon this campus right now and making sure that they receive the love. I mean, you know who I'm talking about, man. It is something for sure.
And, you know, Mike Scowell was very close to Coach Nauter on the women's soccer team. So the way that this season's been going, it just seems like it's fate right now for that team. So hopefully they can get the job done tomorrow against Rutgers-Camden here at MSU Soccer Park.
And as we said, we are currently here at MSU Soccer Park. 1 minute remaining until we get this men's matchup rolling once again. Of course, Montclair will be coming out of the half still with their 1-0 lead. I mean, you could just almost feel like the pressure out here. I mean, look at
this. It's quiet. It's very quiet. Like, you expect for a playoff game the intensity to be like crazy high, fans be loud the whole game. It just hasn't been that. It's been like a more quiet pressure sort of feeling. And, you know, maybe the fans haven't showed out the way I expected it to be. You know,
I mean, we got a pretty good show out here for a Tuesday night. As we said, both Red Hawk Nation and the Scarlet Raptors fan base showing out here. But it has been, you hear them on calls, they come to life, but then they quickly settle down. I mean, I think that you could just feel
the tension,
the pressure. I mean, this is win or go home. This is it. There's no tomorrow. It's right now. This is what you got to do. I mean, And I don't know about you. I'd probably fold under this pressure.
You do?
I think
come
I
on,
might.
You don't have that Mamba mentality, Maz.
I might have that Mamba
mentality. You get that Maz mentality.
That Maz mentality. Well, you know, you already know what it is.
You already know what it is.
I got my own
mentality.
That's
the Maz mentality. You already know what
it is. You
know
what it is. You just keep on going. You make it happen, and you make it work.
What's the Anthony Caffone mentality?
Mom, I'm sorry.
Mom, I'm sorry. I let you down again.
No, dude, honestly, the Caffone mentality is, of course, get it done.
Get it done.
Make it happen any which way. That's it.
That's it.
Last second, always last second.
You already know what it is.
Running around, making it happen. Speaking of making it happen, we'll see if Todd Tumulty and his lads can make the advancement into the final here as we are just awaiting the teams to take the pitch. Of course, Montclair State on the pitch currently. Rutgers-Camden warming up on the sideline real quick, just getting some sprints in there.
And those of you from the Rowan soccer team who are watching, welcome. I know you're waiting to see who you guys are playing in about 45 minutes. So just a little preview on that team there. They've done a good job this year of playing just solid team. They're 13-5, and they weren't even the 2-seed because Ramapo had a better NJAC record. That just goes to show just how tough the NJAC is this year. Montclair beat them the one time they played this year, 3-1. They scored 3 goals. Remember in that first 15 minutes? I think we were on the call for that one. Montclair was able to jump out to it quickly on that Rowan team. Rowan played better for the last, it seemed like, last 35, 40 minutes. They played better. So if they could continue to keep that pace up against this Montclair State team next time around, if Montclair could end up winning this game, you got to expect that that's going to be a good game as well.
Yeah, I mean, and you said it best. And there's some ballers you got to watch out for. I mean, I believe it's Chad Yates for Rowan. I mean, he was phenomenal. You definitely have to watch out for him for sure. We'll see what happens here, but we still have a whole half. Montclair with a slight lead. We'll see if they can add on to it. Finally, teams on the pitch, and you see Sean Boone having just one last conversation as they wait one more player, make sure they get their pep talk in. Montclair State, I believe, we'll be starting with the ball.
This is the back 45, Baz, the second half. Throw up your twos. We said this in the booth during the homecoming game, me, Campbell Donovan, and Charlie Badwini. Throw up the fours when the fourth quarter happened. Throw up the twos now. This is the second half. This is where heroes are made. This is when the game is decided. So for both teams, this is where you have to come out here and really stake your claim. Because if you want to be an NJAC champion, these are the moments where you have to step up.
That's what it's about. Stepping up in big moments, getting the job done. Next goal mentality, next play mentality.
If
keep
I'm
it moving.
Say, your one goal lead is not going to cut it. Not going to cut it.
Absolutely.
Straight up. You got to
stay aggressive.
Stay aggressive. Keep trying to score goals because you can't just be complacent. Oh, we have a lead. That's not enough in these situations. Get another goal. Get another goal. Just keep working at it.
I think Todd Tumulty and his crew are completely on top of that. They've done a fantastic job over this last couple of years turning this program around. Here we go again. Chesney on the ball. Chesney giving it over to Zelanka. Zelanka trying to fight that ball up. Rutgers-Camden taking over now, but not able to get past midfield as Lukovic now speeding past Swen, trying to get that one over to Viola. Viola trying to set up Lukovic with a touch. Come on. And boom, off the line. Ball still into play. Crawford trying to send it towards net. And again, Rutgers-Camden holding on, keeping the ball inbounds. Viola fighting with it. Sending that one out.
Oh,
Sean Boone coming alive right there.
Sean Boone just doing a great job. Had a one-on-one opportunity and just getting his body in front of it, preventing the multi-goal lead. And he's got to look at that. But if Rutgers Camden's able to come away with a win tonight, you got to look back at that play and just say, wow, that sparked it.
I mean, Sean Boone kept him in the game last time. And again, coming strong for them. But I believe this will be a free kick. Pedro Javel Castro sending that one up. And that one headed by Justin Goldberg out of bounds will be a throw-in. And I believe Pedro Javel Castro will be assuming the throw-in. And now a switch of field for Rutgers-Camden. Getting into that far side. Trying to get that ball up to number 8. But Chesney completely on top of it. Donovan Davis sending it back to Lukovic. Lukovic fighting, swims past the defender, racing down now, trying to flip that one over. Looked like Anthony Viola. But Javel Castro back on it. And headed by Rand Doncic. The ball ping-ponging off of multiple heads. And Justin Goldberg showing off some nice control, getting it over to Chesney. Back over to Zalanka.
Yeah, Maz, they're doing the same thing they did in the first half. Just continue to play slow. Keep players across the entire sideline to sideline and just move those passing lanes. And then, you know, it just seems like Rutgers-Camden doesn't have anybody out front ready to receive that outlet pass. And whenever they do that, Montclair State has a defender right there to just scoop it up. And they're doing a good job of just taking those outlet passes and then slowing it back down again as they keep moving up the field.
Speaking of moving up the field, here's Lukovic again in an attacking position. Lukovic sending it towards Sean Boone, hanging on to the heat, showing off the glove strength. And Ant, we actually have an update here again for women's volleyball.
Yeah, the Red Hawks win set number 3 at Rutgers-Camden, 25-18, to take a 2-1 set lead. So they are on the final of the fourth set. If they can be able to win in this next set, they will win against Rutgers-Camden and move on in the NJAC playoffs. So good luck to the volleyball team in that one.
Hey, you saw them drop the first set, and here they are fighting again. Speaking of fighting, things getting just a little bit chippy right there as Javel Castro might have taken a shoulder from Viola. The ref thought so. This will be a free kick this time with number 22, Raimondo Partito. And Partito making sure his guys get up the pitch. Sends that one towards the edge of the box, headed by Rand Doncic. Swen trying to fight for it. Montclair coming up with it. And Josiah Crawford is zooming out there, just losing the possession. And now, once again, Keenan coming, taken. That is going to be a foul against Keenan. They will call a penalty kick as he collided with the forward.
And Keenan's done it a few times today, making a running play to stop the ball. But he just came up too fast. And now, Rutgers-Camden has the chance to tie with a penalty kick.
And just talking with it, I believe This is going to stand.
I mean, I think it's a good call. I think Keenan came in just too fast.
A little too aggressive.
You got to watch yourself in that goalie position, because now you're setting yourself up for a tough chance, and now we'll get the first penalty kick of the game.
Up, things getting chippy down there a bit. Goldberg and Randoncic in the middle of things. And number 8, Ethan Dreyer.
He's pushing.
Dreyer once again, Chesney getting in there. Ref holding strong, and you see players breaking it up, but I believe you saw Keenan collide with number 19, Michael Campbell. Campbell will not be on the kick, though. I believe they're opting to go with number 21, Christian McCartney.
Yeah, McCartney, sub in this game.
Senior out of Old Bridge, they're opting to go with one of the players that they know well for this squad over these last couple of seasons. We'll see if what McCartney can do going head-to-head with the best goalkeeper in the NJAC. Shot coming, and he sneaks it in there, leveling up the game 1-1. You hear the crowd for Rutgers-Camden roaring right now, absolutely ecstatic. And we are all tied up here with 41 minutes remaining.
Yeah, Keenan, a little bit of a mistake, being too fast and aggressive on that play. And now McCartney able to mount it up with that penalty kick. He elected to go left on that save opportunity, and McCartney went straight out. I think the best, if you're taking a PK in a game, I think the best option is just go right at the goalkeeper, because normally the goalkeeper dives either way, just go straight at him. That's exactly what he did, because usually the goalkeepers try to pick a side.
And Goldberg now fighting on this near side, getting it over to Viola. Viola over to Lukovic. Lukovic fighting, getting the ball off as he takes the contact. He's asking for a foul. Ref not giving it. Josiah Crawford trying to come up with it, but it will be Chesney sending it up to Crawford with a little heel flip, keeping it in bounds, and a hard tackle sends this ball reeling, but Montclair holding on to it. Cross coming in, and Lukovic fighting through multiple players again, getting that ball over to Viola, but he will be offsides. And this will be, that was so close for Montclair State. Just inching right there. Lukovic with a potential shot, opts to go over to it, but Viola just a step offside. Second that ball came over, you saw the ref put the flag up. And
it seems like this crowd's a little bit deflated after that one, but the Red Hawks still got good opportunities to continue to just pound the ball. They're doing a good job just continuing to win the possession battle. If they just keep doing that and keep trying to force the ball inside and pick their moments, they're going to get another goal. It just seems inevitable at this moment. But shades of last year, last year, semifinals against Rowan, they lost a 1-0 game, and they lost in the semifinals of the NJAC tournament. So hopefully they can pull away and try to get a W. But after that one, they just seemed a little bit deflated, but continue to work.
And Montclair working right now, and Randoncic almost losing that one. Teammates helping him out there. Brogan Quigley getting it over to that far side. Cutting back in, switching the field of play. Justin Goldberg trying to keep that ball in. Just too much power on it. You see the hands like, calm down, guys, we got this. Just too much on the power. This will be a throw-in for Rutgers-Camden.
Yeah, this Rutgers-Camden team now seems like they have the momentum. Playing good defense in their back third. Getting the ball out, and now they're working to see if they can get that possession over as that missed body pass trying to get over
to Dreyer.
To Dreyer.
And this will be a throw-in for Montclair State. Goldberg launching that one. Swen coming in, though, heading it away, getting this one over to Tittlemeyer. Tittlemeyer gets it up to Prince Bofo. Bofo looking for Campbell. Campbell with Randoncic right behind him. Passing it off. Receiving it back. Montclair fighting. And Tittlemeyer will reset the possession back to midfield.
And now Rutgers-Camden taking a page out of the Montclair book. Just playing slow, playing patient, and not really trying to force too many things. Now Montclair State trying to get a good turnover with Goldberg up the field.
And this will be a throw-in for Rutgers-Camden. The ref giving a talking there with Goldberg.
So update from volleyball. We don't have a set update, but we do have an update on a Montclair State milestone. Senior or graduate student outside hitter Leah Higgins just set her 1,144th career kill, which is the all-time leading killer on the Montclair State volleyball team. So congratulations to Leah Higgins, an incredible accomplishment on a great career for the Red Hawks.
Listen, we've just talked about Lauren Pickle. We've been talking about both men and women's soccer team. Just an absolutely phenomenal athlete here at Montclair State. We do have a player down that looks like number 28, Eric Swen.
And they're calling for an elbow. They're saying that maybe that someone elbowed Swen. It was Perito asking for it. But Montclair State will get a free kick.
Yeah, Partido trying to make something. But anyway, this will be a free kick. And congratulations to Leah Higgins on an impressive career and an impressive milestone to hit. Now leading all time for Montclair State. It's got to feel wonderful. Brogan Quigley trying to get something going. Montclair State fighting at number 8, coming up with it. Ethan Dreyer winning it back, but Ian Chesney getting right in between that one. But the ball finding Dreyer once more. Dreyer getting it over to McCarthy. McCarthy cutting back on multiple Red Hawks. Donovan Davis getting a foot in there. But Rutgers-Camden holding strong. The Scarlet Raptors now looking to have some life, looking to be a little more creative with the ball.
They got a balanced attack here. You got four defenders back, and the four sort of making like a circle shape around the center circle, but it doesn't seem like they're not passing away. And
no call Crawford. There. Crawford looked like he got hooked on that one. The ref saying no. Ball still in play, and now with Sean Boone. That was interesting, but anyway, here we are. Boone sending that one midfield, and a hard collision will send Donovan Davis onto the field. He collided there with number 19, Michael Campbell and Campbell checking up on him, helping him up. That's some good sportsmanship like there. Love to see it.
And this game has gotten a little chippy. We saw a little bit of pushing, shoving after that one penalty, the penalty kick for Rutgers-Camden when Keenan came out there. This is a high emotional game. A lot of implications on the line. A lot of careers are on the line as well.
Ball into the box. Chested down by Goldberg. Just goes wide of the post. Puts his hands on his head, wishing he had that one back. Goal kick for Rutgers-Camden.
That's a tough opportunity, though, because Goldberg's trying to shield at that defender while also simultaneously trying to put that one down and go to that near side post, but it rolls out. Nothing more you can do if your head coach, Todd Simulty.
Yep, I mean, he's got some great tactics here, and it was just one mistake that ended up this game being level-level, but here we have it.
That's soccer. One mistake is all it takes, and that's why I said a little bit earlier, just got to keep playing clean football.
Ooh, and not even a whistle there. The players just knew. Just a hard tackle coming from Zelanka. And that actually shakes up Tittlemeyer. Oh, it looked like he was calling for a sub, but he's all right. He's just going up. This will be a free kick for the Scarlet Raptors. Daniel Tittlemeyer still on his feet. Michael Campbell settling it, gets it over to Tittlemeyer. Tittlemeyer taking in a bump from Crawford. Crawford coming up with it. Lukovic trying to get the counterattack going, but the center back's holding strong. And now sending the ball towards Shane Keenan. Keenan getting it over to Randoncic. Randoncic over to Chesney. Montclair trying to build up some momentum again to get their attack going. Playing it back with Randoncic. Randoncic sends it up, putting that ball deep into Scarlet Raptor territory. This ball will be rolling out of bounds.
Yeah, I don't know what Randoncic was seeing on that one. Tried to just hit deep. He had a couple of players close. Just continue to just stay patient. Work for something, but he tried to force that one deep. And now we have a goal kick for Boone.
And we have some subs coming on.
Number five, Tommy Monahan.
As number five, Tommy Monahan. And number four, Parker Soloway. Come on for the Scarlet Raptors. Checking out, I saw, was Tittlemeyer. And here we go again. Crawford trying to get to it. Ball put up into the air. Soloway going up into the air with Quigley for it. Brogan Quigley winning the ball back. Crawford mishandling that one. Ball racing towards Shane Keenan on top of it. And Christian McCartney was right in his face.
Yeah, good job by Shane Keenan. Staying poised, not trying to be too aggressive like the last time. It will come out of his box, do a good job, and corral that ball.
Randoncic playing it over to Chesney. Ian Chesney gets it up to Murphy. Murphy couldn't corral it, but the ball falling back with Quigley. Quigley heading it over to the side, receiving it back. Donovan Davis calls for the ball. He receives it. Trying to get it up. Ooh, and that will be a foul as Lukovic hits the pitch. Number 37 having a quick little talk. That's Prince Bofo.
A little bit of contact. I don't know if that was enough to warrant a foul.
I don't know if you saw it. I actually saw the cleat take out Lukovic. I think that was a good call.
Okay. So now the Montclair gets a free kick about 35, 40 yards out. They haven't been converting well in these free kicks. They haven't really been getting good hits from Murphy up top. Chesney had a few that were a little bit off the mark. They got to do a better job being accurate on these free kicks, because these are the opportunities that you, if you lose a game like this in a close game, these are the opportunities you look back at and say, we should have converted.
Murphy sending into the box. Beautiful kick there. Zelanka trying to wind that one up, and he sends that one up into the moon.
Yep, so that was actually a good play. They sort of headed it back to Zelanka, gets Zelanka in some space, and he tried to hit that one tee. Try to go to that top upper 90, couldn't get it.
It's so hard to time up those shots. I mean, Zelanka getting the rebound and trying to one-time it. I mean, it's so hard to pick it out of the air like that, but I appreciate the effort there.
If he had hit that, you would have lost.
Oh, I would have lost my mind. Would have absolutely lost my mind. And look at a slide tackle here from Justin Goldberg. Jovel Castro able to show off the athleticism, now showing off the handle as he puts that ball up into the air. And now Anthony Viola winning the ball back. This ball up.
It was a handball maybe off Lukovic.
I was in a natural position, so they don't call that one. Good call there. Clear did hit the arm. You're
it
right.
Did hit the arm.
But so. It was in a natural position. Love the call. And they are actually going to have a stern little talking here with Donovan Davis and Parker Soloway.
A lot of trash talk in this game. Just trying to play mind games with the other team. It's something that you talk about a lot as Goldberg off of the backside
of Viola. That was a nice little cheeky play, trying to make something happen. Couldn't make anything. Keenan almost slipping, able to show up the up down, staying on his feet, getting it over to Zalanka. Zalanka trying to find Crawford. Montclair winning the ball again. Now getting the ball up to Crawford. Josiah Crawford off to the races, into the box, giving it over, and a missed time there. We'll send this one back towards Montclair State. And
yeah, Javel Castro, though, being in the right place at the right time, was able to stay in between that passing lane and step in between. It looked like that was Lukovic from getting that pass.
Did I miss something? Apparently we had a free kick here. Not sure what happened. Donovan Davis trying to come up with it. And Aaron Doncic getting a foot towards Zalanka will last touch at that ball, spiraling out of bounds.
And now substitutions coming in for Rutgers-Camden. These are the games where, even though it's a playoff game, you want to have your best players out on the field. It's just too physical, too fast, and you got to be sprinting up and down. So you got to get your players some rest at some point in the second half.
Well, they brought back in Ethan Dreyer, Michael Campbell coming off. So replacing one starter with another. Smart tactic there. Picking your moments, making sure that you have your top, at least one of your top players.
And that's when coaching comes in. That's where coaching comes in. And you guys say, hey, you know, we want our best players out there in those last 15 minutes. So give them some break now when there's a little bit of, when the other team's twos are coming in. And then when they're all rested up and ready to go for the last 15 minutes.
And this ball falling back with Keenan.
With the way this game's going, we might be seeing some extra time. So you even need them to be more well-rested for that as well.
And this ball flying up the pitch. Crawford, ooh, capitalizing on a mistimed kick there from Partito. Playing it back, resetting things. Cross coming into the box. That one headed by Pedro Jovel Castro. And now Montclair's Anthony Viola trying to keep the ball in. That ball goes out of bounds. Will be a throw-in for the Scarlet Raptors, and some subs coming in for both teams. As you see, number 21, Christian McCartney heading out, and for the Scarlet Raptors, and number 12, Anthony Viola checking out for Montclair State. That looks like number 9 checking in for Montclair State. John B. Cajado, and also number 9, Kahari Shepherd.
I like bringing Kakato in this situation. He brings that speed element to the game. Look at that, just physical, trying to find some space already.
This ball going out of bounds. Justin Goldberg on the throw. Goldberg,
oh, a little misdirection,
out.
A little pump fake.
Dreyer there, trying to get that one over to Kakato. Will be another throw-in for Montclair State.
Goldberg doing a good job in his throw-ins, going up and down the pitch.
Looks like Goldberg's going to try and launch this one into the box.
Probably one of the better throwers of Montclair State.
Sending it in. That one headed ball down and kicked away. Out of bounds. That looked like number 37, Prince Boafo, getting his foot in there. Boafo giving Goldberg another throw into the box. Lukovic trying to go up for it. One-timer.
Oh.
Just not enough on it. Sean Boone beats it to the corner. And
good shot from Murphy there at the left foot. Tried to go to that far side post, but Boone read it like a book. Saw it coming. Did a good dive, slid, and made a good save. Keeping this game knotted up at one.
If Murphy could have just got a little more power on it, I think he would have beat him. But back at midfield. Little collision there. Refs gives the advantage. Crawford gets it up to Lukovic. Lukovic over to Cajado. Cajado now on the edge of the box. Now into the box. Fighting. And a slide tackle coming, I believe, from Swen. Sends that ball out and will be a goal kick. You see Sean Boone giving some clap and loving the defensive effort there from his team.
Yeah, the defensive effort from the Scarlet Raptors in the second half has been apparent. It's a much different team so far. They seem a lot more aggressive, a lot more ready to turn those opportunities away. And it just seems like this after that PK, it just seemed like this team's gotten more energized.
And there's the advantage there. Donovan Davis get it up to Lukovic after a hard tackle. Lukovic now on the edge of the box. Sets up a corner. That is a great job by that referee, allowing the advantage right there.
Yeah,
wow, the nerve to let that play on. Most people would have blew the whistle. Hey, this guy so far, 10 out of 10 for me. Anyway, here we are on a corner from Montclair State.
Is Lukovic in that back corner there?
Free Jonathan Davis. Anyway, here we have it. Corner from Montclair State. Sending it low, missed time there. And now you see Chesney with the hands in the air, not liking that one. And a through ball coming out. Keenan, well out. Keenan kicking that one off the pitch. Number 8 was lurking. Ethan Dreyer was ready to capitalize on that one. But great job from Shane Keenan just staying active.
Yeah, Keenan, I mean, he's been ultra aggressive this game. I mean, he's been aggressive in the past, but it just seems like this game he's just trying to snuff these opportunities out right before they're even opportunities.
And speaking of opportunities, Rutgers-Camden will have a corner now after Parker Soloway hits that one off of Justin Goldberg.
I believe this is the first corner of the game, too.
I think you might be right on that one.
So now you get to see Kari Shepherd take the corner on the near side, and I want to see what Rutgers-Camden pulls out in this corner opportunity and what their opportunity is going to be.
And before this corner comes, Ant, we actually have an update on volleyball. Hit us with it.
Montclair State Volleyball wins in 4, 25-12 on the fourth set. They advance to the semifinal at Rowan on Thursday. So good job to the volleyball team. Congratulations on the win.
And the corner coming in, and that one headed by Chesney. Now headed by Josiah Crawford. Cagado trying to race for it. Parker Soloway on the ball, bouncing back and forth. And they're trying to get it back in, and they do. Hand ball not called. They were asking for it. No, refs gave it. And this, and now things are getting pretty chippy. As you had a Parker Soloway just colliding with Keenan. Keenan not liking that one. Soloway.
Dangerous play.
Listen, he gets the yellow card.
That's justified. You can't be coming at the goal like that.
You can't be pushing guys after that. I mean, listen, once again, great job by the ref. Only a yellow card. I love it. Let him play. This is fantastic. But you can't be doing that. Listen, we've seen Soloway last time. I believe Soloway picked up a yellow card last time these teams play. You know, we got a couple of guys that get a little heated out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
But Shane Keenan doing a good job of just staying with that play, going up for it. And even after he got taken out there, able to get that ball right back. As Montclair State trying to go back on the attack again.
Chesney sending that one up. Crawford in the action there. That ball put up in the air will fall back with Lukovic. Lukovic trying to get over to Cajado. Cajado not ready for it. That ball going out of bounds will be a throw-in. 22 and a half minutes remaining here on the Red Hawk Sports Network's coverage of Montclair State Soccer. Brandon Morazzo joined by Anthony Caffone. And now ball pinging off of multiple players. Owen Murphy will have it now. Over to Donovan Davis. Davis trying to fight up with Lukovic. Lukovic with Swen in his pocket. Missed time of it, and a slide tackle from Quigley is avoided there by Ethan Dreyer. Now Rutgers-Camden on the counterattack. Too much on the through ball over the top. Keenan on top of it, looking for, they were looking for number 14, Liam Craver. And now this ball up to Crawford. Josiah Crawford cutting it back in, giving it over to Owen Murphy. Murphy back over to Lukovic. Lukovic cutting back in, sends the left foot shot in off a defender, but wins it back. We have a Montclair player down. And we'll see who that is in some serious pain down there.
Seems like his cleat came off.
I believe that looks like, is that, I believe that might be Crawford. I'm not positive, could be Murphy.
Maybe twisted an ankle and that's why his cleat came off.
And we'll see.
That's actually number eight, Murphy. Owen Murphy, yeah. Yep.
Murphy not happy having to redo the cleat.
But yeah, now Montclair State, it just seems like after that PK, Rutgers-Camden's had a new life. They've been playing much more aggressive. They've been getting stops. Montclair State not having many shot opportunities here in the second half. But you look at this Rutgers-Camden team, only two shots taken so far today, and one of them, of course, was a PK. So it's not like they're getting the great opportunities. They're just doing a good job of just playing physical defense and then converting on the PK that they got. But, I mean, the credit for today right now has to go to the goalkeeper, Sean Boone, today. Five saves, four of which were extremely difficult.
Ball into the box there. Hit away Chesney. Corralling it, as you were saying about Boone.
Yeah, he's been great today. Five saves. I mean, four of them were pretty difficult saves. A couple times he had to dive and make a sliding save. So he's been great today in keeping Rutgers-Camden in this one.
And that was a
offside penalty.
Weird call for me. I mean, he could have called it on first contact. Anyway, I believe that might have been not quite sure who got caught off there. I believe Alex Zelanka got caught offsides, and this will be a free kick here for Rutgers-Camden.
So Boone will try to, they migrate most of their players to this far sideline. You got wide open here. Looks like Kari Shepherd.
Yeah, Kari Shepherd with some space. They didn't notice him, though. Jambi Cajado trying to get in the middle of the play. This ball now with Pedro Javel Castro. Castro sending it towards the edge of the box. Parker Soloway trying to shield off a defender. And Cajado getting that ball up for Crawford. Crawford now with some space, cutting back, giving the ball up, and Grant Williams sending it back towards Montclair State's territory. Keenan coming out.
Just seems like a back and forth between both teams. They're just doing just not really getting that offensive opportunity. It's just been a defensive game right now. I mean, Montclair State was able to convert on a great shot from Lukovic early on in this game, and then a PK was the only score of the game for Rutgers-Camden. That was a McCartney PK. So it just hasn't seemed like both teams have been clicking on the offensive end. The defensive end, though, they're just doing a good job of just sliding over in the passing lanes, getting turnovers, getting tackles, and translating it to the other side.
And speaking of passes, this one heads over with Justin Goldberg. Goldberg cutting it back with Davis. Davis sends it over to Lukovic. Lukovic to Goldberg. Into the goal, and a great slide tackle sends that one out of bounds. That was dangerous. What an effort there from number 22, Raimondo Partito, but the danger's not averted yet, as Montclair will have a corner. Some subs coming on right now. But the passing, did you see that?
So 1-2, 1-2, right in front. And it looked like that was Radoncic in front there. We could have finished that one. Just a good slide tackle by Partito to let that opportunity go to pass.
Yeah, you saw the ticky-tacky-esque play there, and then looking to get a cross in, trying to get one of those nice little tap-in goals. Sending it in. That ball bouncing. Crawford now on it. Crawford handed over. Cross coming in to the box. Just too much for number 19, Chris Fontanazzo.
Yeah, Fontanazzo has done a good job this season being a facilitator for this Red Hawk team, trying to go on that far side and maybe make a header. He's not one of the taller players on this team, sitting at 5'7". So I don't know why they would try to do a high pass to him on that play. But now you get a goal kick for Rutgers-Camden.
And Boone sends it once back more. Donovan Davis with a strong header. This ball now up in the air. Bouncing around. And once again, Donovan Davis showing off multiple attempts, winning that ball back. And now Grant Williams trying to head it. And then, wow, a booming kick. Sent it back to Chesney.
Chesney had to go back on that high arcer. Good kick there from Rutgers-Camden.
And now again, Montclair trying to make something happen. I believe that was John B. Cajado, couldn't hang on to it. And will be a throw-in, this time with Grant Williams.
A few times, you just seen the players have just not been able to handle passes today. A couple mental errors, slipping on the wet turf. Just been all over the place today. A couple of mistakes have led to a tie game right now. So the Redhawks got to do a better job just cleaning up the passing game and setting up their opportunities.
And now Davis gets it over with Cajado. I'm sorry, Crawford. With Crawford, I believe. Passing it back with Quigley. Randoncic on the ball, turning around, gives it over to Justin Goldberg. Goldberg getting it over to Fontanaza. Fontanaza trying to get it over with Lukovic, but number 37, Prince Bofo, right on top of things. Throwing again, setting things up with Randoncic. Randoncic crossing the field to play with Zelanka. Alex Zelanka now giving it over to Crawford. Josiah Crawford back to Quigley, and Montclair slowing things down a bit. Getting it over to Goldberg. Goldberg trying to put a cross there, but nobody home.
Now, when they let Crawford work in space, that's what this offense is truly deadly. Just let Crawford work on that wing. Let him either try to do a cross pass inside or let him just run around as a player hit the dirt there.
And an offside call will come. Player did hit. Fontanaza was battling, trying to see who that player is. I believe that might be Pedro Jovel Castro.
Yeah, that is. That is Javon Castro.
Man, I know my lineups, don't I?
Yeah. But, one thing about Crawford, work with the space on that right wing. Let him either work with his footwork, because you said it time and time again, Matt. He has the best footwork on this team.
It might be the best footwork I've ever seen, man. Outside, non-professional? I mean, come on. When I'm comparing you to Neymar, you're the real deal, bro.
So he does a good job on that right wing of just getting space, able to work to that inside. And then when he needs to, he could, hit a cross pass as well. So letting Crawford facilitate that offense from that right wing has definitely been a good job, has been a thing that the Redhawks love to do a lot, and they haven't really been doing that so far in the second half.
15 minutes remaining here. We'll all level up at 1-1.
Michael Campbell.
And Michael Campbell will check back in for Rutgers-Camden. Montclair, though, getting this ball over to Cajado. Cajado passing it back with Goldberg. Goldberg looking, thought about sending it to the other side. Opts to go short with Quigley. Quigley with Randoncic. Randoncic finally switching the field of play. And you see Goldberg with some space over here.
To Crawford.
And Crawford cutting back. Look at that one. Williams with the recovery, though. And again, ending up to get in front of him, stop the breaks, take the contact. That is a great defensive play there by Grant Williams. You might not like it. It is a little cheeky, but it works, and it wins the possession back, and you will live with that any day of the week.
That's the only way you can stop Josiah Crawford. Just get in front of him and just put the brakes on. Force him to sort of, because you can't stop. When you're running that fast, it's hard to stop yourself. So that's why they've been getting penalties on, or fouls on him today.
It's such a smart play, honestly. And now again, Bofo getting it over. This ball boomed up looking for Campbell into the box. And oh, that is lucky right there to say get up. Justin Goldberg almost in a dangerous situation. Goldberg sending it up now. Lukovic trying to get onto it.
Oh, good move.
Pedro Jovel Castro winning the foul against Chris Fontanaza. And Goldberg Just checking real quick. Crowd not loving it.
A little bit of contact.
I'm hearing a mixture. You're hearing guys saying get up. You're hearing this and that.
It's tough because, like, this is a playoff game. You got to be careful. You got to, as a referee, you got to sort of, this is getting physical game. You got to sort of contain the physicality and not let things get too far. But also, you don't want to make a call that could directly impact the game. It's such a tough spot for a referee in these playoff games to really make a play.
Absolutely, as Pedro Javel Castro sends that one towards Montclair's box. I'm now getting a foot on it, jumping into the air, Karate Kid style once again. His foot control and being able to just pick the ball out of the air, stupendous.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And
he is better than probably anyone on this team right now.
I would have blown out my knee, my hammy, trying to attempt that one. Anyway, this ball bouncing around, and that will be, for your basketball fans out there, looks like an over the back. But going back with the no call with Goldberg, what you feel about that contact? That was scary.
I don't think Goldberg kind of landed in his landing zone, so that's why maybe I would have said you call a foul there, but it could go either way. I wouldn't have been upset with either or in that situation. So.
Oh, can that open a chance? Sending it, and how did Sean Boone hang on with that one?
He had to stay in the same spot. I didn't think Kagato got enough power on that kick. He sort of got up in his shoulder area. Had to just kick it down his left foot. And good job by Boone sticking with that play and making another great save.
And now Daniel Tittermeyer trying to get a ball through, but Aniran Doncic right there to stop it. Shot coming towards Keenan. He's on top of that one. That one coming from Ethan Dreyer. Montclair State picking up the pace. Get it up with Josiah Crawford. Crawford cutting back. The patented cutback.
Oh,
beautiful. Still racing. Hands this one off. Looks like Fontanaza. Fontanaza getting it over to Kagato. Kagato slowing it down. Back to Fontanaza. Takes it. Playing it back in. Lukovic sends it. Goal! Once again, Lukovic coming up for this team. Getting it past Sean Boone the second time in this one. The Red Hawks take the lead.
Amir Lukovic doing it again for the Red Hawks. Second time he's gone to that backside post, beating Boone at his own game. And continuing to play dominant, the top goal scorer for the Red Hawks this season, adds another two-goal game tonight, and the crowd is electric right now. They've been waiting to pop off all night, Maz. They get the opportunity here with 11:21 left.
Wow. What a goal at what a time. Do you see Lukovic still saying, I love it, I love what a man, you know, who gets the job done and then lets you know about it a little bit. Amir Lukovic. Fantastic. And then you see, look at this. Goldberg getting a water from the crowd. Getting a sip in real quick. I believe that might be his father. Shout out Papa Goldberg on that throw. And you see MSU Soccer Park coming alive once more.
If this was a real soccer stadium, like a 40,000, that's the time when the fans are going absolutely crazy. And even though this isn't like a big stadium, you don't have a lot of fans here tonight, this is just an electric atmosphere.
I don't know what you're looking at. Look at all these people out here. Kagato fighting for it. Now, don't get me wrong. Compared to a MetLife Stadium, no. But this is a beautiful stadium here at Montclair State Soccer Park. Both fan bases showing up. This game giving you everything. We're here, man. We are here, baby. We are here. Once again, Goldberg trying to play that one in. Prince Bofo getting in between that one now. Getting their Rutgers-Camden getting that ball over with Tittlemeyer. Oh, and a no-look pass. Setting it up there for Ethan Dreyer. Dreyer winning the corner.
Uh-oh, so now good situation here for Rutgers-Camden. They have that corner kick on that far side. And a few times they've had some good opportunities from these corner kicks. So now you got to just see if you can go to that far side post. It just takes one perfect kick, Maz. Just one perfect kick from the Scarlet Raptors team, and they could tie it up. They've responded before. I mean, they only have about 9 minutes and 48 seconds left. You need to show a little bit more urgency. They're not really hustling to that corner. not hustling to get started because you don't have any time to waste here.
9 minutes and change. Clock still ticking. A low corner coming in. Josiah Crawford taking on contact. Still holding on. I believe that was Raimondo Partito trying to stop him. And again, Montclair still trying to implement the press and trying to force a turnover. This ball going out of bounds in favor of the Scarlet Raptors.
So now Scarlet Raptors right at midfield. See if they can design throw in here and try to work that inside. But a good job of this back line all day today. They've just been doing a good job of just getting back, stopping any pushes in pursuit.
And that ball will be a goal kick as I believe that was number 19, Michael Campbell was trying to get a call there. But did you see Josiah Crawford just bulldoze Zalanka? Zalanka getting up, showing how tough he is. Crawford showing the fight of a champion right now, getting it done. Dude, he is a wing, tracking all the way back, contributing anything, any way he can. I mean, the effort, outstanding. That just goes to show how great. To me, that just shows, one, the character of Josiah Crawford and this squad, this mentality, but it also shows Timothy and his squads, the way they just have these gentlemen playing. I mean, fantastic.
This attacking line, Lukovic, Zalanka, Crawford, they've just had a great run so far this year. Just going up and down the field. I don't think you could say that any one position on this Montclair State team plays their singular position.
They're rotation fantastic.
They rotate a lot. They're always in the right spot, and they just prevent any opportunity that just really that comes by.
And a great effort there by Goldberg. Goldberg with the ball now, sending it over to Brogan Quigley. Quigley over to Zalanka. Zalanka coming back towards midfield, gets the ball over with Crawford. Crawford on the side, sending the pass in. No nonsense clearance coming from the back line, sending it out of bounds.
And if you're the Red Hawks here, you have a one-goal lead, 7:38 left. There's the instinct to play conservative. Just pass the ball around, don't make mistakes. I still think you try to go for another goal. Just keep working inside. Don't go too conservative and play scared, because that's when you're more inclined to make a mistake. Just play hard and try to fight for another one.
And this ball falling back. And Michael Campbell showing off the jets, trying to catch up with that one. Now lurking on Keenan. Getting it up to Congato. Cajado.
Oh,
losing the possession.
Leg.
Did you see that from Pedro Jovel Castro? Trying to send it. And a little shoulder bump there. Nothing much though on Randoncic. This will be a throw-in.
And looks like one last substitute for the Scarlet Raptors.
Yep, number 5, Tommy Monaghan checking out. Checking in once again is number 9, Kari Shepherd.
Try to get your height in here. Yeah, Kari Shepherd at 5'10". A couple of 6'4 players on this Scarlet Raptors team. Try to see if they can win those 50-50 headers. But I got to say, the Red Hawks today, they don't have a single player on this team over 6'1". And they have been getting a lot of these 50-50 headers. And that's what's been the tide of this game as well.
And Lukovic now, once again, showing it off. Passing it over. Look at the unselfish goal coming. And Sean Boone holding strong again. Unbelievable.
And if you are Rutgers-Camden, you cannot be upset with the play of Sean Boone today. I mean, 7 saves. 2 goals allowed against Lukovic, but the saves have kept them in this game. I mean, Shane Keenan only has 1 today. He hasn't had many opportunities to face. It's just been Sean Boone rising up to the occasion today. Unfortunately, if they don't get the win, it would have just been a spirited performance gone to waste.
And now this ball with McCartney. McCartney cutting back towards midfield. Sends it, and Keenan doing the nice, look at that, veteran move right there. Grabbing the ball, falling to the ground, making sure you're covering it, just making sure he can click, tick off some extra time here. That is a crafty move. You see the ref call him for it. Gotta watch he doesn't pick up a card here for stolen. And he sends it. Ooh, that ball hitting right into Lukovic's chin area. Ball being sent back. Keenan on top of it. Look at him. Once again.
Playing Count Mouse right there.
That is just a, that is veteranship right there.
Playing cat and mouse, keeping the ball away, kill some more clock.
The graduate student knows exactly what he's doing.
He's having a great game today. I mean, the only goal that he's let up, of course, is the PK, and sometimes there's nothing much you can do on a PK than just try to just pick
you know,
a side.
I've always heard, I gotta be honest with you, I'd rather have an aggressive goalie than one that's afraid to come off the line, so you live with that one.
Yep.
Yeah, no, and he's... He doesn't have many saves here because they haven't really let many shots on goal. But he's been coming off the line, making sure nothing getting past him. Great effort. Speaking of great effort,
oh,
Ian Chesney with a torpedo header there. And offsides will be called.
He kind of looked
against
like
Montclair.
He kind of looked like a dolphin coming out of the water. You know, he's a big, like, little just arm to his side dive. He went that ball. That's actually pretty funny.
That wasn't even the effort I was talking about. Yeah. There was a Scarlet Raptor with a couple of chuckles there, and then Ian Chesney with a perfect time torpedo header.
That was hilarious.
What an effort.
He looked like a dolphin though, right? Like coming out of the water, diving hands at his sides.
I mean, that could not have come at a better time.
Wow.
Oh man, here we are, just under 4 minutes. Sean Boone booming it across the midfield. Amir Lukovic with some good control, sending it trying to chip there. Boone on top of it.
And good job of the left leg there from Lukovic, about 55, 60 yards out. Trying to go all the way, but good power though. But a simple save there for Boone.
Justin Goldberg going up into the air, winning a foul. Christian McCartney colliding there with Goldberg.
Tenth
foul. You see Donovan Davis coming over and dusting off his player a little bit, saying, hey, dude, I got you. Good effort.
10th foul on the day for Rutgers-Camden. 14 for Montclair State. That just goes to show you how physical this game has been. A lot of foul calls. It's just been back and forth. Both teams just trying to generate more contact.
Oh! Did you see the effort there from Lukovic? Juggling it, getting the shot off, but Boone able to hold on.
I just love what the Red Hawks are doing right now. They're still going for that third goal. They're not staying complacent. They're not trying to play too conservative. And they try to kill some clock with Shane Keenan on that side. But they just did a good job of just continuing to play their game and not get away from it, because playing conservative is not going to help you in this situation.
And now Swen coming up with it, and a hard slide tackle coming from Brogan Quigley. We'll put the ball back with Amir Lukovic. Lukovic getting it over to Kagato. Kagato slowing the pace down now. Cutting back in. Oh, I saw what they were trying to do there. Fontanaza calling for Lukovic to get in there, but to no avail. 2 minutes remaining here on the Red Hawk Sports Network's coverage of Montclair State men's soccer, as they are currently up 2-1 against Rutgers-Camden. This ball falling.
2 minutes away from an NJAC title berth.
And some contact. Ref says get up to Campbell. Montclair now with the possession once again. And the ball falling back with Boone. And you see him, a Red Hawk racing. That is Owen Murphy trying to get something going. Through ball over the top. Goldberg heads it. Kagato going hip to hip. Jovell Castro able to keep it in, but Goldberg right on top of it as he's taking on. Ooh, that is a beautiful effort. That ball rolling out of bounds. That's number 28 on the slide tackle, Eric Swen.
Stay with us here on the post game. After the game, we're going to have women's soccer Julie Baker join the post game show after this one, but hopefully see if the Red Hawks can hold on this last minute.
This ball falling back. Pedro Javel Castro under a minute here. Sending it. That ball headed by Goldberg. And the ball able to stay in bounds. And again, Pedro Javel Castro just sending it in, looking for a prayer, trying to make something happen in that area towards the Montclair goal. And this ball hit by Donovan Davis, making Sean Boone come out.
And the countdown starting.
And that will be it. And there you have it. The playoff berth stays alive. Montclair State takes this one 2-1 off the back of Amir Lukovic with two goals. What an effort. Anthony Caffone, what did you think on that one?
Great game. The Redhawks punched their ticket to the NJAC final for the first time since 2019. You mentioned Lukovic, two goals in this one. Chesney picking up an assist in that game as well. It was just the Redhawks dominating the time of possession, getting good ball movement with the passing, and they were able to just play solid defense. And for Rutgers-Camden, a hard-fought, spirited battle. Their season will come to a close, but you just got to just give props to the players there. They play hard.
Yeah, man, what a game it's been. We actually got a special guest in the booth, as promised. Julie Baker is joining with us. Julie, how you doing tonight?
Doing great. I mean, their energy was really inspiring. I hope that we can bring the same energy tomorrow. It was a great game overall.
And, you know, as you just alluded to, tomorrow you guys are taking on Rutgers-Camden yourselves. How are you feeling going into that one?
We're super excited. I mean, we've already played them in the NJAC one time. We're looking to play them hard again tomorrow night. I think it's going to be a great game. They're a great team. So hopefully we can bring the same energy.
And, you know, last time you guys faced them, you guys had a pretty impressive win, I believe 3-0. Is there anything that going into that, even though you guys had a dominating win, does that affect, I mean, what's the mindset? Are you kind of taking them, not necessarily more seriously, but how are you feeling about them coming in, even though you beat them in such a convincing way last time?
Oh, yeah, no, we're not taking anything for granted. They were a great team the first time that we played them. We had, again, it was only 3-0, so we still have a lot to prove. This tournament is insanely incredible. All the teams are great quality. So, yeah, we're looking forward to tomorrow night.
And you know, your squad's doing a fantastic job. I mean, you guys are just steamrolling out here. And Aileen Cahill and Kylie Prendergast have been zooming all over the place, tacking on the goals. I mean, what's it like playing with them and just playing a part of a team where you guys really just get after it?
Oh, they're insane. Aileen and Kylie, oh my gosh, they have such a connection. It's so amazing watching them play. They light up the field, so they're inspiring us every day.
And, you know, every time you go to a women's soccer team, a women's soccer game, you see the men's team popping out. Every time you see the men's team play, if you guys are on campus, you guys popping up. Just what's it like having such a great soccer community here at Montclair State?
Oh, it's a great support system. I mean, like, we see them in and out of soccer. It's just great being with everybody. We have a great community. We're just excited that we both won the NJAC championship for the conference. So we're hoping to move that into the tournament.
Hey, and congratulations on an amazing season. Just one last question here. Can you just share what a head coach and owner has been encouraging you guys with? What has been his words as the season's going on, getting into tournament play here?
He's been telling us a lot. But I would say, for one thing, he just says, just play the next play. So just anything that happens, flush it. Make sure that you're just focusing on what's going to come on next, and don't take anything for granted.
Hey, Julie, thank you very much, and good luck tomorrow. We truly appreciate you. You guys have been fantastic.
Thank you.
All season. Now coming back here with Anthony Caffone. And we just saw Montclair State go to war and come out on top again this season.
Maz, this team has shown the resiliency all year. A couple of draws. They actually draw this Rutgers-Camden team not even 9 days ago. And they come out here, get two goals from Amir Lukovic, who continues to sparkle in year number two with the Redhawks. And it was just a testament to this team's resolve. I mean, they a tough penalty down the box by Shane Keane leads to a penalty kick goal for Rutgers-Camden McCartney. And it could be easy right there and then and there to just say, all right, tough play. Now we lose momentum. we could just lose this game. But no, they said, you know what, let's play back into our game, do what we do best. This game's not over, still a tie game, nothing ball game. And then they gave it right back to Mir Lukovic, who goes to that far side post, hits that goal. Absolutely electric atmosphere at MSU Soccer Park, and they'll be back on Thursday to do it again.
And, Ant, talk about that Thursday matchup. I believe it's Friday matchup.
So, Tuesday, Wednesday's women's soccer, Thursday, Friday. So, would the men's be playing, women's be playing 2 days in a row?
No, I believe Montclair State's next game should be Friday. Over the, I believe,
oh, yeah,
against Roman.
Friday, Saturday. Yeah, that's exactly right. All right. I just had my days mixed up.
Yep.
No, yes, they will be playing Friday. And, yeah, it's a great game against Rowan. Montclair State in the NJAC final against the reigning NJAC champion, Rowan Profs, who are probably watching this game, watching it unfold. Now they know that they'll be playing Montclair State in a few days. And it's going to be right here at MSU Soccer Park. Last time these two teams played, we were on the call for that one, Maz. Great game. That Montclair State had 3 goals in the first 15 minutes and were able to pull away early. And then Rowan got one more goal and was able to bridge the gap, but that was it. Montclair State won 3-1. So it should be a very entertaining game between these two teams. I mean, this is the second time Rowan will have to make the trip up to MSU Soccer Park this year. So get ready for a fun NJAC championship. Red Hawk Sports Network will have the coverage of that game as well.
Hey, speaking of that game, as we said, you also got field hockey coming up November 2nd against Rowan University. As we just said, volleyball got the job done, I believe, down in Rowan, right?
No, down Rutgers-Camden.
Down in Rutgers-Camden. My apologies.
And now they will actually be playing the semifinal game at Rowan at Thursday. So volleyball is playing Rowan on Thursday. Men's soccer is playing Rowan Friday.
Too many things popping off around here. This is what happens when you have great athletic teams going deep into the season. We can't even keep count of the dates.
Mass. So Montclair State playing Rowan on Friday.
Yes.
Here at MSU Soccer for men's soccer. Volleyball is playing Rowan on Thursday for volleyball. And then you have field hockey playing Rowan as well. So the Rowan-Montclair rivalry going deep in the NJAC playoffs this year.
And don't forget about the women's soccer team, as they will be going tomorrow night. Check out the coverage. You've been watching the Red Hawk Sports Network. Brandon Morazzo joined by Anthony Caffone. We'll catch you next time. You